I welcome you all in another series of the top 10 updates of the month, the top 10 updates in the GST. And we have with us none other than Advocate CA J.K. Mittal ji with us, a renowned personality, and all are eager to hear from you. And earlier two occasions, he was in Nagpur and people still carry the memory of that. I would say the program name is the top 10 series, but people would love to hear again and again from the from you, not top 10. It may multiply as per your convenience. It's always a pleasure to have you at this session in Nagpur. I would request chairman of the Nagpur branch, C.A. Saket Pagadia ji, for his welcome address.
Thank you so much, sir. When you have a person sitting in front of him whose name is J.K. Mittal, you know, you find just that you are just at the best of the places, because he is the best person who can explain you about anything and everything about starting from service tax and now into GST. We are really privileged to have CA Advocate J.K. Mittal sir as the speaker for this very important session, the top 10 series, GST part 3. Friends, this GST, this top 10 series was envisaged with the concept of that there are so many amendments, so many judgments, so many changes which are going on, which as professionals, we need to update ourselves. For that, we just need to have a top 10 series. That was the concept wherein we said, okay, fine. Everything which can be covered in these areas can be covered well in this topic. We're really privileged to have CA Advocate J.K. Mittal sir for delivering on this topic. Friends, the very, very important sessions which sir is going to cover today, I feel everybody is going to be more interested on the topics which are going to be covered. Fake invoice. If I say fake invoice, everybody is like, okay, fine. Ye kya ho raha hai? What are the things which are happening out here? Summons, arrests. Yes, we are really wary about that. Buyers getting GST credit when seller does not pay tax. Recent court decisions. I feel there are so many things which are going to be with Mittal sir. Time permitting, whatever best sir will cover, we are going to relish that. We are going to cherish that. CA Naresh Jakhotia, the coordinator for the sessions, Yakshay Gulhane, the treasurer of the branch, and all respected members who are present in large numbers for this very important session. I welcome all of you to this very interesting session on GST by a very renowned, down-to-earth, expert faculty, personality, chartered accountant, advocate, J.K. Mittal, sir. We welcome you, sir.
Thank you, Chairman, sir. Friends, we are with us Advocate CA J.K. Mittal ji. He's a chartered accountant turned advocate, a law graduate from Delhi University, and a practicing advocate, particularly in indirect tax, in High Court and Supreme Court. There are numerous judgments to his credit, and there are few landmark judgments. The arguments are worth listening. He is a co-chairman of the National Council of the Indirect Tax, ASSOCHAM. Supreme Court Bar Association has honored Mr. Mittal for 9 consecutive years, and also in the year 2016 to 2018 on the occasion of Law Day and Constitution Day. We all are aware he is the author of several renowned book of the country, Law Practice and Procedure of Service Tax, Introduction to GST, Handbook on Equalization Levy, and Handbook on GST Law. No matter how many times you listen to him, no matter how many times you talk with him, you always find it inspiring. It's an always mesmerizing to hear CA Advocate J.K. Mittal ji. I hand over the floor to him. Sir, over to you now. Please, sir.
Thank you so much, Saket ji, chairman of the Nagpur branch, his colleague Naresh ji and his entire team for giving me this opportunity. So many kind words has been said about me, I will assure all of you, though you are in this webinar, I will make this session as memorable as Mr. Naresh ji particularly has generated a lot of hopes. And the topics, of course, which has been chosen, or have been chosen very carefully, which are a day-to-day talk in the entire country. Let me begin and, my session by sharing the screen so that this different kind of, I don't like, to all these things, but since the changing scenario of we have to go by, you know, the webinars through online, so that all you can remember, we have already shared, you know, this with the chairman of the branch, and it will be circulated. Therefore, there is no need to take notes or, you know, pen down anything from the screen. If you will listen carefully, you will enjoy more. Let's begin with, you know, I'm just showing, you know, the list of the topics to be covered so that one can see on the screen at a glance. One thing I have decided with the chairman that we have the two options, either to cover everything or to enjoy the session, go in detail, maybe leaving some chapters so that we can discuss something more in the next time. And the second options for going in detail has been chosen is the better options. Friends, this is the very first slide, is very important. This covers, you know, the views of the Supreme Court, which was aired by the Supreme Court in the April 2021 itself, while hearing the writ petition related to the, or the SLP related to the GST, in which the fake invoices issue was flagged, but the core concern was about the bank account attachment of the assessees. And ultimately, this case has been decided in favor of the assessee. But what is the point I would like to make here, which you can see the Supreme Court said the GST Parliament intended to make it a assessee-friendly tax. But the enforcement agency has made it draconian law. Therefore, the Supreme Court has given the clear-cut message. And Supreme Court also said, all these things have been reported in media. I have picked up from the Google and you can check it. And though I have the personal knowledge of all these facts were transpired in the Supreme Court also. They said the taxman cannot see all businesses as fraudulent. And this why I have flagged it, because of the our issue roam around these issues of the fake invoices, summons, bank attachment, etc. Therefore, as you know, my friends were talking that there is no need to fear at all. Even if the Supreme Court is saying the taxmen are, you know, blaming someone as a fraudulent or using their power to make this law as a draconian law, despite that the parliament had no intention to do it. Therefore, to begin with the about the fake invoices, let me tell you that it has become a buzzword in the entire country. Why? You are hearing that every day there are certain arrests are being made, and the newspaper, you know, they carry the story which is being told by their own officers, saying that we have unearthed, you know, 25,000 crore racket, 5,000 crore rupees racket, this and that. Whether these are really happening or all these are, you know, as fake as the fake invoice. I have reached a conclusion that the fake invoice, you know, or the fake news or the this fake arrest, these arrests are being made, that is correct. But the grounds for the arrest or whatever they are, you know, publicizing, that may not be the correct ultimately once these cases will be taken up in the court. Let's start with the very first concept. What exactly is the fake invoice? Firstly, this term has not been defined in the act at all. This term has been coined by the department only. And department has coined the term. If you hear the department, it is not a fake invoice at all. They do not know what is called as a fake invoice. Therefore, our concept should be very clear. What could be the fake invoice? Fake invoice could be if somebody raise or make an invoice is my name. If somebody put the signature in my name, that is called the fake invoice. Fake invoice is not an invoice which I have given to someone. I record in my books of accounts, other side record in books of accounts. That can never be called as a fake invoice. But unfortunately, the number of cases which I have handled, even today I got the 7 such cases. And every such cases which they blame is the fake invoice. None turned out from 2007 to till date is a fake invoice case. Every case is a genuine case which the department is blaming as a fake invoice. Why I'm saying so? If you ask to the department, department will concede that yes, this is an invoice you received from the B entity. It was raised by B, it was signed by the B entity only, but still they call it as a fake invoice. How it could be a fake invoice? Therefore, your concept must be very clear. If your concepts are clear, law understanding is clear, then I am sure the officer will be afraid of you, not the you or your client. Therefore, it should be very clear. Unless until you are handling an issue, ki your client himself has generated the invoice's name of XYZ people. Unless until he himself put the signature of someone else, this invoice can never be called as a fake invoice. Therefore, our concept should be very clear that I have never come across even a single case since 2007 to till date, even a one case of a fake invoice. Mr. Chairman, somebody is, you know, writing in the screen. I think you have given, you know, some right to someone. Ask them not to disturb the screen at all.
Please, I request everybody.
This screen, you can see, you know, somebody is crossing from the red, etc. Now let's go to the, you know, the further to go in details. When, if you understand this fake invoice concept, you know, they said it is a circular trading. Now I'm sure, as the name indicate, everybody can understand what is a circular trading. But we will still discuss in just one line. The circular means like a ring. A supply the goods to the B, B to C, C to D, D to E, E again to A. It become, you know, it started from one hand and reach in the hands of the same person. That is called the circular trading. Now question arises, even if there is a circular trading, is it barred under the law? Answer is no. If something is not barred, you can always do the activity. So therefore, what's wrong in it? Though it appear to be quite amusing to someone that why it is a circular trading. It can always happen. If you go in a, you know, the share market, if you go in a stock exchange, you know, like this, I think there without delivery, you know, everything happens. There every time that I will sell the share in the morning at 10 o'clock, may purchase the same share maybe by 11 o'clock, may sell it again by 12 o'clock. Therefore, neither the circular trading nor the time and again you are changing hand of those commodities is barred under the law. If something is not barred under the law, you always can do it. Therefore, as a chartered accountant, what we should appreciate, only one thing. That only can increase our concept and, you know, the caliber as well as confidence. And the confidence always matter to handling any cases. The simple concept is that if the law does not debar you for something, you always can do it. Like some year back, you could have entered into the cash transaction maybe of 10 lakhs per day or 20 lakhs per day. I believe under income tax now it has been barred up to 2 lakhs something, maybe a year or with one client, etc. Therefore, unless there was a bar, you could have done it. If there is a bar, you have to follow it. Therefore, there is no bar at all. Neither it is a fake bill, nor the circular trading is banned. You can do it. Now you go further to understand the department, you know, modus operandi. Then how they said, you know, the transactions, you know, take place about then, why they are doubting it. Their doubt is that they try to say that there is no supply of goods. How they come to know there is no supply of goods? Is it that the goods will remain at the stagnant or the same place? Goods will be consumed, it will change hands. Another, you know, concept they introduced by saying that no, there is no supply of goods, as well as they further, you know, make an allegation that you are not entitled to take input tax credit. Now, the 2-3 things we have to understand here. The first thing is that whether physical supply is always required under the law or not. Secondly, even if there was a physical supply or not, how the person can verify it? Therefore, as soon as the officer say there was no supply of goods, you should be very happy rather than to worry about it. And that is the really the concept you have to understand. And before I proceed further, let me say a very, you know, practical example. It was around 22nd of January 2021. One of my chartered accountant from Ahmedabad called me. He said his client in Mumbai is in trouble of the same very issue of fake invoices. And we want to have the conference when the search is going on. And we want a tip just in 3 minutes, the three tips, so that not only our confidence, we gain it and we can get out of it. And I told, you know, three lines in 3 days, there will be the allegation, non-supply of goods. There will be an allegation of the fake invoice or circular trading. And you just say, if there is no supply of goods, you just give us in writing and we will be very happy. And on 27th of January, once he was called by the department, he was afraid he would be arrested. And once I met him physically, I visited Rajkot, you know, one chartered accountant, you know, residential course took place this year only. Then I asked him what happened. He said, ki, I just, you know, told to my client the same line. And as soon as he told it to the officer said, Baba, you go back home. Because if we will accept your arguments, my entire case will go. Therefore, if the officer is saying, let me repeat it, you should be happy if say there is no supply of goods. And how you would be happy? Just wait for a few minutes. Everything will be before you. Therefore, if the department make an allegation, we have to understand the law. And we read a law, not section 132. Maybe the another section you read first, and then we will come section 132, whether it can hurt you or not. Therefore, two, three things more you understand whether there is a supply of goods or not, which I will tell you in this way. If there is no supply of goods, then how you will understand this? Suppose let's take the example, 2 years back in your office, you have, you know, offered your guest, you know, some cookies, you know, maybe some, you know, cup of teas or maybe samosas, etc. And you purchase all these items. And you have a today invoice to prove it. You have another document to prove it that you made payment through the banking channels. But if the commissioner of GST still say, no, it is a fake invoice. There was no supply of goods. Then how you will prove it? Because all you have eaten up at that time a year back, today it cannot be proved that whether you eaten it or not. You will prove only with these two documents. The invoice you have, the payments you have made, which is in recorded in your books of accounts, he can go to the other agency from where I purchased it. They will also confirm to it. And that agency may exist today or may not exist today because that is not in my control. Therefore, understand section 9, which is displayed, you know, the one line on your screen, saying that the section 9, when the GST is applicable, that is a concept we have to understand. GST is applicable. GST is leviable as per the charging section 9 if there is a supply of goods or services or both. Therefore, if the officer says there is no supply of goods, do you come within the ambit of the GST? That is the question you have to ask yourself. Let me give the another example. Suppose the income tax officer say to you, you have to pay income tax, but say this is not an income. You will laugh it or not, particularly end of the session, Mr. Naresh will react to it. If commissioner is saying you have to pay income tax, but it is not an income, I'm sure you will be so happy that you are going to win this case because he himself has considered it is not an income. Therefore, if he's saying it is not a supply of goods, and if you are aware of section 9, you will say only the supply has come within the GST. If he himself saying there is no supply, can you tax to me? Can you collect any tax for anyone? Therefore, they want to take benefit by making so much of hullabulla, which is beyond the law, which law does not permit and law can never permit. If something is permitted under the law, you can challenge that law. If some circular today CBDT issue, you are liable to pay income tax, but the law says income tax is only on the income, then of course the circular is not binding upon you. Therefore, the thinking of the commissioner should not go in your mind. That is the first message I am passing on to you. Therefore, if he make the supply, then you understand, go back to the previous slide. What is their modus operandi? They come to B
entity B, once I said A, B, C, D, E, they come to the entity B saying that you are not entitled to take input tax credit on the invoice which you have from the entity A. The grounds they tell you that there was no supply of goods. Even if it is assumed that there is no supply of goods, then how you can handle and tackle it as per the legal provisions? Let me make it very clear, whatever we are discussing, which is, you know, the argument you can take in the law. I'm not telling something, you know, you just fight it out and you just kill someone. It is not the for the purpose of, but your concept fundamentally is correct and still you don't have a confidence, then something wrong with you. Because if law we understand, then you don't worry about the, you know, officers, what they are saying. And that's why I deliberately chosen the first slide. If the Supreme Court of India is saying they made the law as a draconian law, which Parliament never intended, so therefore, what message more you need other than a Supreme Court, if the Supreme Court is saying so? Therefore, you must make it very clear, the officers are going beyond the law. They are making life tough of everyone because they have become very corrupt. And I don't mind to use these words. And that's why the present government has used in 2014 the term, we want to end the tax terrorism. Therefore, even before they take over as a prime minister and the finance minister of this country, they were very clear that there is a tax terrorism in this country. And they also said, we want to end the corruptions. Therefore, if we understand that, who are at wrong? Who are at wrong? Wrong not the assessee and the taxpayers. Wrong are the officers. And if we understand it, then our confidence will be clear. Our low understanding become more clear. They only have the power. Initial life could be tough. They make the bogus cases. But ultimately, they will not win those cases. And that is their track record is showing. If you see the 70-year history of this country, 85 to 90% cases go in dustbin, those who are booked by the tax authorities. So that is their success rate is only 10%. Therefore, 90%, maybe 10% they are losing because of the interpretation of the law. Substantial cases are bogus cases they are registering because you are not paying them the bribe. Or even if you pay them the bribe, still they want to have more and more bribe and want to kill someone. Therefore, that is the understanding of the law. So you understand this concept. If they come to the B, they said no credit will be available because there was no supply of goods. Then you raise a question, if there was no supply of goods, why you collected a tax from A? I already paid the tax to A. That means I'm entitled to a refund for it. And more mockery, you understand, more mockery, once they said, no, you are not entitled to take a credit, you pay the tax on the entire amount. Let's say you purchase a goods of 10 lakhs and you want to sell it for 11 lakhs. What the GST said, the tax on the value addition. Ultimately, you have to pay the tax only on 1 lakh. But what they are trying to teach us, they said, no, there was no supply of goods. Therefore, you are not entitled to the tax credit of 10 lakhs. You pay the tax on 11 lakh. And then they goes to the C. And same thing they repeat to at the C also. They will tell to the C, you are not entitled to take a credit of the bill of the B because there was no supply. Therefore, you also pay the tax on the full amount of 12 lakhs. Now you understand a concept. What is GST? GST is a tax on value addition. You can't collect a tax from every person on the full value. That means very objective of the GST you are killing. The basic concept, basic funda of the GST is the tax on the value addition. And if you start collecting tax, that means you accept there was a supply of goods. Is it not correct? If you collect a tax, that means you conceded there was a supply of goods. Therefore, if they collect the tax, there is an implicit things, there is a supply of goods. And if there was no supply of goods, onus is on whom? Not on you. Not on your client. Onus is on the department. How the department will prove? The department will, what I will say, that they will be within their web. They will not be able to come out because they cannot take contradictory stand. Therefore, you see, one of the judgment I have, I want to show, this Welltex case, this will be find fit. And let me tell you this judgment, how I learned about this judgment when I was doing my law from Delhi University. Therefore, nothing goes waste. If you are studying law carefully, you can pick up, you know, something from the what you study as a student. I still can remember a multinational company came to me more than 15 years before. And the very peculiar question they asked, they had the multiple clients, you know, or the one client with the multiple bills, which, you know, the payment shall be adjusted against which payment, because it was the issue of excise. And, you know, we had a lot of problem. Then I went back to my intermediary study material of the CA. And what is the appropriate appropriation of payments, you know, the law under the Indian Contract Act. And I got a lot of money and I got successful that case also. Therefore, this case, what is this case under the Wealth Tax Act? There was a one property at the Kasturba Gandhi Mark at New Delhi. And the Wealth Tax Commissioner said, this is an assets. Therefore, it is liable to the Wealth Tax. He chartered accountant was very intelligent. He said, sir, okay, if it is an assets, it is liable to Wealth Tax. Then read section 5 also. It is an exempted assets. And if it is an exempted asset, ultimately you can't collect the tax. But the commissioner argument was that for the purpose of levying Wealth Tax, it is an assets. But if you will claim an exemption for that section, I will not treat it as an assets. The matter ultimately went to the Delhi High Court. Delhi High Court said, we can't understand this philosophy of the department. If the commissioner, while collecting tax, say it is an assets, but while exempting, they said it is not an assets. This argument can never be accepted in the law. Therefore, the same argument under the GST law, while they collect the tax from ABC, they said it is a supply of goods, you pay the tax. And when you try to claim the input tax credit of the invoice of A, the B claim credit, or invoice of B, C claim a credit, they take a stand that it is not a supply. That, to my mind, nobody will buy this theory in the law. You can't take a dual stand. The same officer for the same very company, same very transaction, you can't take these dual stands. That will be illegal under the law. Therefore, to my mind, these fake invoice cases, don't worry. If you have your bill, if you have made the payments, that is fine with you. Now go further. You know, sometimes they allege it. You know, like, you know, I mean, the credit, they want to deny it to you for the grounds other than the grounds mentioned under the GST law. Before going to that, now another concept we understand, can the tax can be collected from the multiple person? If you read the section 73 and section 74, which is the, you know, the section which you can call it as a loose language of assessment, or you understand the legal language, they said that this is the proceeding they initiate under the GST law by way of issuing SOCOS notice. If the SOCOS notice are issued under section 73 and 74, and if you read that section carefully, it clearly states the SOCOS notice can be issued to a person who is chargeable to tax. Now, who is chargeable to tax? Who makes supply of goods? If a person hasn't made a supply of goods, you can't issue him a SOCOS notice. And the second is the SOCOS notice also can be issued if a person liable to tax has taken wrongful credit. Therefore, if he's liable to tax and a SOCOS notice is issued, then the wrongful credit only could be on the ground mentioned under section 16. 16.2 makes certain condition. Section 17 makes the certain credit can never be taken. But those are not the issue here in the so-called fake invoices cases. The issue is a little different. He, in the minds of the commissioner, in his perception, ki there was a no supply of goods, it is a fake invoice. That is their perception, and law does not work on the perceptions. Law is very serious and strict. One has to go by the legal provisions. Therefore, this is not the legal, you know, things where the commissioner can succeed on these issues. I'm very clear about it. Therefore, we have to understand the fake invoice, circular trading, and then input as credit denial, whether these are justifiable in the law or not. Therefore, you can't deny the credit on the grounds that the person from whom you have purchased the goods, he has run away, he is not in existence. Recently, one client came to me. He said, he's from Punjab. He said, when I purchased the goods, he was in existence. I paid in the tax. He paid the tax to the government and he filed the return. Now he is run away. He is not in existence. Then the commissioner said, you pay the tax because we are not able to trace him. Law is not like that. If you are not able to trace him, that is not my outlook. You have given them the registration. You should have done KYC. You should have keep control over him. I cannot keep control over him. So that is not the law which is casting any burden upon you. Though there are certain conditions which has been, you know, put it in the law that whether the vendor has paid the tax or not, which we will, you know, discuss subsequently because we have a separate topic today on that, that I will discuss it. Therefore, that is the fake invoices concept. To my, I have not seen even a single invoice. Now the certain people came to me. I asked them, what documents you have? If you want, I should handle your cases. They said, we have invoice, we made the payment. The entire entries are reflected in the GST return 2A, etc. And normal course of business, we are making payment also. There are some outstanding that is always be there in any business. Nothing wrong about it. Then we ask about the e-way bill, etc. He said, we have the e-way bill. Now the question, you know, one person asked me, how I will be ensured that this e-way bill, the whatever, you know, vehicle number is mentioned, etc., whether that exists or whether of which vehicle, etc., that is not your outlook. If he's making a wrong vehicle number, nowadays everything is, through the web. Why not the government of India punch every vehicle number, connect with the transport authority? No vehicle number which is like a scooter, etc., can be picked up. So then what is, you know, your responsibility is very limited. As a chartered accountant, now you understand, you know, there was a judgment from Punjab and Haryana High Court where, you know, the chartered accountants were being harassed by the GST department. Now, what is the role of a chartered accountant in these cases? Chartered accountant act in a various capacity. He could be the auditor, maybe the statutory auditor. He could be the auditor as a GST audit was, you know, there or still there as of now. Or he could be an advisor to his client. Or his job may be to file GST return, even maybe to prepare the books of accounts. Can he be held responsible? My answer would be no. Because you are working as a professional. You are not working as an investigator. I still can remember when I joined CA. The very first eligibility test paper I have given, there was a question probably in the audit exam for eligibility test that auditor is not a blunt whom. He is a watchdog. Therefore, how you will verify? You are not supposed to verify and go that whether that company exists or not. You see through the documents. Your job is limited to the verification of the documents. Whether you are punching entry, you are filing return without even having the bill. That may be wrong as a professional misconduct or professional negligency. But you cannot be held liable for fake invoices or faking it because you are not indulging in those transactions. Transactions are performed and done by your client only. You are as a professional. Whether you file return, whether you are doing auditing, etc. But if you find something, you know, very gray area or something doubtful, you may qualify your reports. You may ask certain questions. You may exchange certain emails with your clients. Show me the certain documents and you can safeguard yourself. But in practical life, sometimes the officers, because in India, to my mind, the officers don't like anyone. They like only the money. And that's why they start harassing it. That you have to see if you live in India, sometimes to certain extent, you have to cope up with all this situation. But long time, this tendency will not work because the department, if you make a complaint, and today I made a complaint to the Prime Minister about one of the commissioners. I made a complaint to the Central Vigilance Commissioner. So you become so much of daring, you will learn that don't mind to make a complaint even against the commissioner, chief commissioner, maybe a minister. If he's indulging in the wrong thing, you have a full right. Therefore, harassment is not permitted under the law. But if in normal course, he has a right to make an inquiry and you feel an arrest, that you have to cope up with it because otherwise the officer will also not able to work at all. There may be a very genuine case in his hand. So whether genuine or not, that department will see from their point of view, and we will see from our point of view. But to obviate this kind of harassment and, you know, a long drawn litigation, you can approach to the court. If you feel it, he is going misusing his authority. he is unnecessarily harassing you, you can approach to the court and make these kind of arguments. Now, real battle starts from the summoning. If these issues comes, they have the two weapons in their hand. One weapon is the summon, other weapon is the arrest. Summon they issue and arresting, you know, the threat they give it to you. And as soon as the threat of arrest looming on the head of anyone, he start begging, he start, you know, arranging certain funds. That is quite obvious, whoever may be, you know, something. But sometimes if you are quite confident, the officer will not be able to, you know, put hands upon you. Because over the period of time, law has undergone significant change. One incident happened long back when one person committed a suicide and Supreme Court has given a detailed guideline that nobody in the entire country could be handcuffed. If you remember, long time back, the people were, you know, handcuffed by the police and taken to the jail. Now you never see the people is not never handcuffed. Similarly, they made so much of guideline. You can't arrest people like anything you feel it. We will discuss some of the judgments like this. Therefore, if you know about your rights, you know about their limitation, and you just make noise about a couple of things, you know it, he will be quite vigilant before taking any action. And you can make complaint against them, then only they will understand. So let's understand how this summon has become a very draconian things. How these are being misused. In any law, you will find power to issue summons. I can remember probably section 131 and 132(4) under the Income Tax Act. Similar kind of power has been given. And today, fortunately, Mr. Naresh is here. We will just try to, you know, pick up something from income tax and to understand how we are benefited. GST law, you have the lot of benefits, but only the fear, psycho fear we have in our mind. I can say if I interact with 100 chartered accountants in my life to discuss about what is the modus operandi of the department in the income tax and how you deal with it, I feel neither the client nor a chartered accountant afraid of any income tax notice. If I say the same SSC has received two notices today, in the morning income tax notice, he will just say, okay, after dinner we will talk to Mr. Naresh. But after 2 hours, if he received a GST notice, he will just say, lunch I will not eat today. Let's first contact to the GST consultant. That is the psycho fear has been created. And there is no need for this psycho fear. To the income tax, you have more power. If you read the search provision under Income Tax Act, I think it run into the 2-3 pages. But here the search, you know, the provision just in 3 lines. When the search can be conducted. Similarly, the power under the GST for the summoning is very limited. But these are being misused. And we have not understand how they are misusing it. That's why we feel the summoning is a great power. Summon power is there in every act. Anybody can be summoned. But the question is that whether you are concerned with that or not. If you are not concerned or summon is not required to be issued, that is a question we have to see. Therefore, you kindly see this provision, which is just of 3-4 lines only. If you include the heading of this section, it is only of 4 lines. But if you ask me, I can go and speak more than 1 hour only on these 4 lines. That is the depth of this section, and we will try to as summarize as possible. Therefore, the summon could be issued not by every officers. It only can be issued by the proper officers. And this word you must understand, which Supreme Court has explained just a couple of months back. In the beginning of this year, they have explained what is the meaning of the proper officer. It is the proper officer can never be understood any proper officers. The means a very specific officer. Therefore, who is very specific officer? We have to find out and we have to understand. And as soon as you understand that he is not a competent officer, that means he has illegally issued someone. And in every law you understand like that. today, agar in Income Tax Act, if a notice is issued under Section 148, which is after 7 years or after 10 years, you will be very happy. You will immediately say it is time barred. Don't worry. But the same thing you never say under the GST law. That is the problem. Problem is not, you know, in the law. Problem sometime to understand the law. Therefore, as soon as the summon comes, we start, you know, replying it, responding it, feeling it, without even understanding that whether it was.
I request the person to kindly mute, actually, do not create any disturbances. Chairman sir, was it?
We'll just do this.
Yes. Then, you know, you see the second point. First, the person who could issue it. The second is that when it could be issued. It is not like that as and when he wants, he can issue it. In practice, he is issuing like this. But if you read this, when he considers necessary. He only can issue a summon to any person when he considers it is necessary to issue summon. And when it will become necessary, he has certain document before him. He has applied his mind. He has recorded a reason in the file. Yes, so and so should be summoned. Then only it is a legally a valid and a proper summon is issued. In fact, if you read, even today I see my, the letter which I wrote to the Prime Minister in 2014, a detailed letter about the administration of indirect taxes. Thereafter, number of measures were taken. One of that measures in 2015, a circular was issued. And circular says that before you issue a summon, you take the permission from your higher officers. You record the reason for issuing summons in the file. And once the summon is issued, you record the entire proceeding in the file. And let me assure you, nothing you will find in their file. Because in most of the cases, their target is to make money, not the genuine investigations. That's why you should be very clear. If you want to challenge, you can challenge in the court. He has not applied his mind. It was no necessity to issue the summons. Then the third, summon can be issued for the limited purpose. In practice, you see, they issue the summon for what purpose? Whether you are liable to pay GST or not. Whether you are entitled to take input tax credit or not. For these purpose, summon cannot be issued. You have to very clearly mark in your mind that the purpose of summon either to collect evidence or to call for certain document or the things. Collecting evidence means to recording your statement. And we will see in the next slide, there are limitations, lot of limitations for recording statement. He can't ask, whatever the question he wants. No. Similarly, he can ask only the documents. He cannot direct you to prepare the documents. Therefore, who can issue the summon? The proper officer. When a summon can be issued? When he considers necessary. And the another things in an inquiry. Therefore, the summon only can be issued in any inquiry. If no inquiry exists, summon can never be issued. Meaning thereby is that the first inquiry should exist and then the summon can be issued. But in practical life, what they do it, they first issue the summon and then because of the summon, they start an inquiry that is not permissible in the law. Therefore, if you see, these judgments, you will understand more clearly. The Supreme Court judgment of the canon, which was delivered in 2021, it clearly states that the proper officer, the summon can be issued by the proper officer. And Supreme Court said the proper officer means not any officers, only that particular officers. So here, who could be that particular officer? Only those particular, that particular officer who has the power under the law to conduct an inquiry. And who is conducting an inquiry? That is the proper officer who can issue. If you have no power to conduct an inquiry, or you have the power, but you are not the officer who is conducting an inquiry, you definitely cannot issue the summon. And that is clearly stated by the Supreme Court, the meaning of the proper officer. Secondly, my own judgment in ebis.com. If you see the summons, I see day to day, in the summon, they will ask you to bring the copy of the return, GST return 3B, GSTR 1. Second thing, they will ask you to prepare a reconciliation between 2A and 3B and this way, that way. What does it mean? They are asking you to prepare a document. But what the law says, he can call a document. Same thing I have taken in the ebis.com. In ebis.com, when the summon was issued by the deputy director, DGCI, asking my client to give us the information in a tabulated form, we refused. We are not your servant. We will not give this information. You only have the limited power to call a documents. And documents are those documents which are in existence. Which are not in existence, that can never be termed as a document. If you ask me to create a document, I will not create. And that's why in this case, Delhi High Court asked the DGCI Council, do you have any power? He said, we don't have any power. Then the High Court says, sorry, if you don't have a power, you can't ask to create a document. Similarly, document can be called. Somebody's, you know, mic is open and I'm sure he should close his mic. It is creating a lot of disturbance.
Yes, sir. Sir, let me try again. Yeah, I will just go through it.
Yes, either you close the mic of everyone and then I can unmute.
Yes, sir. We are muted actually all. Chairman, sir, anyone there who can control this?
Because I have no problem. Only thing is that, you know, the audience should not feel like that. Yeah, I'm telling something they are not able to hear. In physically, you know, they can interact. Yes, virtually, they will. This. Let me continue. And then you see, you know, in this case, once, you know, they ask to create a document, they refuse. Now the next question arises, the kind of document they ask. Like they ask the form 2A under the GST. You ask yourself, I asked one of my junior, hey, what is the form 2A? Because I don't deal in the form, etc. He said, it is a auto-populated forms on the website, GST portal. Then how the officer has the right to ask me to produce it? He should go to the GST portal, ask him to give the, you know, form 2A. Therefore, the chartered accountant should not accede to this illegal demand. He to submit those documents which are not in your position, which you have no power even to generate. You are not making, you know, those form at all. Similarly, sometimes they ask you to give the form 26AS. What is this? Do we generate form 26AS? As per my understanding, the form 26AS is the auto-populated form by the income tax department at their portal. Therefore, he should go to the income tax department to ask it. They ask you to furnish the bank statement. Bank statement is of the bank. He should go to the bank. He can't come to me to submit a document. That statement may be related to you. But the who originated this statement, he has the right to ask from him. If you submit it, it is a fake. Because how you can certify a document which is not a document prepared by you? Therefore, these are the legal things you must understand. Now, one more things related to the summon is become very clear, then you would be quite confident about it. If they record your statement, sometimes, as I was just telling you a few minutes before, they sometimes ask the legal questions. Are you entitled for these exemptions? Are you liable to pay tax? If you are not liable to pay tax, justify it. These are the questions cannot be put at the time of recording of statement. In simple word, officer has no power to ask any legal questions. No legal question could be asked while recording a statement. Statement only can be recorded in any law. leave aside the GST law, whether income tax, GST, sale tax, income tax, or any other law, whatever PMLA or police law, whatever law you understand in the earth, he has a right to record a statement only limited to the facts. And that's why, while statements are being recorded, law does not permit you can carry your advocate. Because you need not to have any assistance from your advocate or a chartered accountant, because they have no power to ask any legal questions. But still they ask, and still you try to give it. And as soon as you give these legal question answer, you will be in trouble. Let me share it with you. It is around 2006, when I was arguing a case, Delhi High Court, very senior judge asked me, your director has given a statement, yes, you are liable to pay tax. I said, I'm sorry, my lord. If my client is competent to answer to any question, if he will start saying that he's not liable to pay tax, would you accept it? These type of question can never be recorded in the statement. And he understood, and he said, aage chali, aage chali. And ultimately, we succeed in that case till Supreme Court. Therefore, if he asks such question, you simply answer them, these are the legal question, I'm not competent to answer. Just, if you have some agreements, he can ask the copy of the agreements. But if he asks, what is the meaning of this clause of the agreement, you refuse to answer to those questions, because he has no power under the law to ask these questions. Very good judgment, you can read it. I have collected, you know, a couple of income tax judgment. In fact, I don't practice under the income tax law. But the number of judgment of income tax I still read, because these are always helpful. And a Calcutta discount company judgments, if you can remember a Constitution Bank judgment, what the Supreme Court said in that judgments. Assessee job is to make a full disclosure. Nothing beyond that. And the officer should not make any mistake to understand assessee is going to assist him. Assessee will not assist him. It is the responsibility cast upon the officer to draw the inference from the document, whatever his mind says. So don't try to take any assistance. He will not assist you. He is not your assistant at all. Therefore, while recording a statement, they make a lot of noise to threat you, which is illegal. In fact, their own manual says neither a repetitive summon can be issued, nor the summon can be issued other than the office hours, except in the rarest cases. Summon should be issued in the normal business hours. Statement should be recorded in the normal business hours. If it cannot be completed, it can be continued next day morning. But he cannot harass people. But in practical life, they ask you to sit entire night, and you should immediately make a complaint. If those are who are not aware of, let me tell you, Supreme Court is very concerned about it. And as early as 2021, Supreme Court has passed an order. All the agencies in throughout the country, whether GST, income tax, police, PMLA, DRAI, CBI, anybody, those who have a power to record statement, this statement should be recorded within the CCTV camera. And those CCTV cameras which has inbuilt to record your voice also. And further that, these CCTV footage must be kept safe for at least 6 months. If somebody make a complaint, he can make a complaint, and you have to hand over those CCTV footage to them also. That what I'm showing, even the Supreme Court has understood it is a cause of concern, because officer exceed their power. However, when it would be implemented, how, to what extent practically it would be successful in our country, that the time will tell. The Supreme Court has given these directions. It may not be implemented, because those who have to implement it, they themselves are guilty of it. And those, you know, aap chor ke haath mein tajuri ki chabi denge, तो आपकी तजूरी सेफ रहने वाली नहीं है. बट द लॉ इज लाइक दैट, यू नो, यू हैव टू हैव गिव द पावर टू द ऑफिसर टू रिकॉर्ड स्टेटमेंट, टू मेक इंक्वायरी, इन्वेस्टिगेशन. बट ओनली कंसर्न इज दैट दे आर अब्यूजिंग इट. इफ द एक्चुअल गिल्टी पर्सन इज टू बी, यू नो, पनिश्ड बाय देम, एवरी इंडियन विल बी हैप्पी. व्हाई वी आर कंसर्न अबाउट देयर 90% केसेस, वी फाइंड दैट दे आर टारगेटिंग सम पीपल, दोज हु आर इनोसेंट पीपल. Today somebody will say XYZ person has been arrested and we have unearthed, you know, 500 crore rupees fake invoice fraud. His life will be ruined. His family life will be ruined. After 6 months or so, he will get out from the, you know, every hassles, or maybe after 6 years. By that time, what would be the fate of his life and his family? Therefore, we should be concerned about it. That's why we are discussing their limited power. One another important factors, you know, I would like to tell you that whether on the spot statement can be recorded at the time of search. That is the question you have to ask. But if you ask my friend, Naresh will say, yes, it can be recorded with the Income Tax Act, if I can remember, 132.4 permitted. But there is no similar provision under the GST law. If without a legal provision, it could have been recorded, there was no need to make amendment under the Income Tax Act. Income Tax Act made a specific amendment. It can be taken on oath at the time of search, but here it could not be. Why? Why it could not be? You have to understand it. Because if Section 70, you have seen clearly, if you have not forgotten, it says only the proper officer can record it. And proper officer, only those proper officer who is conducting inquiry. There are, you know, multiple check and balances. In the legal parlance, it would be said like that, every legal provision has certain safeguard so that the power is not abused. But once a proper officer given authorization to XYZ subordinate officer to conduct a search and make seizure, so his authorization is limited to conduct a search and to make seizures. Neither he can authorize, neither he can delegate the power to record a statement, nor he has authorized to record a statement. But he carries the summon in his pocket so that if he doesn't make a money, he will threat with the summons. Therefore, that modus operandi we have to understand. And everybody has a right under the constitution. You can engage any advocate of your choice, legal practitioners. And you have a full right to defend yourself. Or aapne to dekha hoga, jo terrorist hai, unko bhi defend karne ka right hai. To aapka client jo innocent hai, usko kyun nahi right hai? Merely because a superintendent, you know, or a commissioner make allegations that he is evading tax, etc. Does it mean it is correct? Therefore, we have to understand this concept very clearly, that this cannot be done. And on this parameters, you know, it remind me a very good anecdotes. Let me share it, their performance of the department. One boy was doing CA, and in CA, everybody CA knows, you know, if CA, you know, doesn't pass in any stages, it is not unusual. Many people, you know, failed in many attempts. The one of the students who failed consecutively third time, and his result was about to come, and or a result was just came. His father called as usually to know about his son, and he called him, asked, "Beta, kaise ho?" He said, "Very fine." Then, and the father all of a sudden said, "Yeah, your result was about to come. Has it come?" He said, "Yes, Papa." Then Papa asked, "What is your result?" He said, "I repeated my last year performance." As soon as the word performance, you know, the Papa heard, he was very happy, banged down the phone. But after 5 minutes back, he again called. Once he recollected that the last year my boy was failed, he said, "Beta, you said I performed last year performance." "Yes, the last year you were failed. This year also you failed." "Yes, Papa. So you never told me that you are failed." Said, "I told you that I repeated my last year performance. I never said I pass out. It is your understanding, how you understand it." So when Mr. Modi called his officer, "What is your performance?" They said, "We repeated our last year performance. For the last 70 years, 90% case, we lose it and still we lose it." So that is their performance. If their performance is so, then you should be very happy. Then winning chances is 90%. 90% you are going to succeed, and their cases are fake. And if you ask my personal experience, almost 100% case are fake. Because मेरे पास तो वही केस आता है जो बिल्कुल जेन्युइन केस होता है. मेरे पास कोई चोर उचकरे आते ही नहीं है क्योंकि हम पैसे लेते के काम ही नहीं करते. The last judgment, you read it, whatever I told you, something I find recently from Calcutta High Court observation in para 30 of this Menaka Gambhir judgments. The three beautiful lines they have written, which can be, you know, supported whatever I have told you about section 70. A gazetted officer must make an inquiry. Same officer must consider the attendance to summon necessary. Therefore, the same officer who issued the summon must conduct an inquiry, and attendance also must be before the same very officers. And in GST law, you will see, like I am recently handling a one case of Bombay client before Gujarat High Court. What happened in that case? The same very fake invoice and you summon search, same drama. Once the client has handed over the document to me, I find out, and very surprisingly, the officer who conducted the search, he put the signature on the panchnama. On the spot, he issued the summon and he recorded the statement. And on the summon, the signature of the same very officer is different than the signature he has put on the panchnama. Same day, 6 January 2021, same officer in the same premises signing two documents. And it is not a slightly different. It is altogether of a different person. So therefore, what you call about a fake invoice is, it is the faking of the summons, faking of the identity even of the officer. That is, I am telling you my own experience with the document I possess, I am arguing. And in fact, surprisingly, the department has conceded in the court by filing an affidavit. These are the two different signatures, but we have warned the officer, he has to put one signature. Which is not the question of, you know, asking him. We have asked him to let it go to the forensic lab so that we can find out is the same person of the different fake identity. So therefore, don't worry about the fake someone. Second thing I want to tell you, when this proceeding was going on, in between the another summons came from another officers from same very department. Then how the summon can be issued by multiple officers for the same, again, same assessing for the same inquiry, and both officers are writing, I am conducting the inquiry. If Naresh issue a summon, Mr. Naresh write, I am conducting an inquiry. If Mittal issue a summon, he write, I am conducting an inquiry. Same GST inquiry, same period, same assessee, same things. What is this nonsense? If as soon as you will point out, I am sure, not always, 95% cases you will succeed in these cases. Therefore, we should not make, you know, before us an example of one case you lose it. Sometimes it's happened in a country like India, very good case you lose it and very bad case you win it. Very, very good Prime Minister was said to have lost, Mr. Vajpayee. And very bad Prime Minister we have seen, he won successively. In my view, he was not successful. I'm not making a political statement. What I'm understanding that if you give me a case, I understand these in this way. I don't consider what is his degree. I consider what is my degree to argue my case. Therefore, don't understand the power he possesses. He's a commissioner. What would happen if he's a commissioner? I already told you, I am telling you plainly, I made a written complaint to the Prime Minister before this conference started. I make sure this is dispatched today itself, and that has already been dispatched. Therefore, if you understand the legal concept and you vouch it, you go back. Those are the chartered accountants who are hearing this conference today. If they have the certain summons, they have the certain documents, they will find summons are being issued by the different officers. Summons are being issued asking those very documents which Mr. Narendra Modi government has made it very clear. We want to have a digital India. What is this digital India if I file the e-return and still you ask the copy of that? And I will write the Prime Minister, this is the officer who is the most corrupt officer. And why I wrote today, you must understand, sometime they issue the summon from private email ID. Government made it very clear, every official communication must be from the official email only. And I made it very clear to write very bold letter, why personal email ID? Why not these will be sealed? His office should be sealed. Personal mobile number. You are indicating in the communication personal mobile number. What does it mean? You come and meet me and to make money? Nobody will speak in this language I am speaking to you. Because these are the cases where that's why you can understand these are not the fake invoices. These are the fake officers, fake identity, or these are the corrupt officers who make the life of everyone hell. And that's why Supreme Court again and again saying the GST law was a good law, good attempt by the parliament. It made draconian because nobody will come in the way if you catch a wrongful person, those who really indulge. And wrongful and indulging in the tax evasion is a different, and tax dispute is totally different things. Tax dispute always can happen. Two opinion, your and my opinion may not match at all. But that is a difference of opinion. That is not an evasion. Therefore, we have to understand this concept clearly. And I'm sure as soon as you will go back, these asking bank statement 3B, 2A, this, that, your perception will change. And start writing in the similar fashion. If somebody approach me, I may charge 5 lakh, 10 lakhs. You know, I charge, my fees is quite high. And those who are dealing with me, they have, you know, not only got the result of it, their faith and trust on the law has increased. I said, once you will give me the document, I can find out, you know, how the officer is wrong. Today, I got the 6-7 files. Can you imagine the summons has been issued? GST summon, I'm telling you. And carry the same DIN number, same DIN number. It started with the income tax DIN number. And same very day, I message to the finance minister, why only the income tax, why not the GST? And they very few days, they started in GST. Can you imagine a same DIN number on the number of summons? How much faking it could be? And I'm sure maybe by tomorrow, I will write to the Prime Minister about with these evidence also. This same DIN number are being used in the multiple things. Nothing more fraud than anything else. Then what is the use of DIN number? It has no benefit at all. Therefore, you should be very careful. If they are making allegation upon you, you can make a perfect things, not an allegations against them. You verify the first their DIN number, what time it was generated, what is these things, and you will start investigating all these things. Because the idea of the government, you understand what is the government is thinking and what the officer is thinking. Government thinking your life of the taxpayer should be ease. Therefore, no contact point, everything virtual, so that the question of changing hands and bribe will get away. They said everything online so that nothing, there is no audit trail they are maintaining because of the DIN number. If you send starting without DIN number, communication through private email, no audit trail, that means anytime you can remove it and you can make money. And I'm sure many commissioner will pass on this message, and I'm threatening them more than a prime minister. This is not their era, they can make money like this. They have to behave under the law. Why they are not having the DIN number pre-populated, pre-printed DIN number? Why they are not making communication through the official email ID and official phone number? Why they are not mentioning it? Therefore, let's now the arrest. Arrest is the biggest tools. If you remember the Om Prakash judgment, I will show in the subsequent slide. That time there was a worry because the excise law was the most draconian law. And Supreme Court said every provision of the central excise, service tax, etc. is non-cognizable. That means no arrest shall be made. The people were very happy. Thereafter, the parliament made the amendment in the law, service tax, excise, custom, etc. to make certain offense as a cognizable offense. Same thing is now under the GST law. Certain offenses are cognizable offense, where the power has been given to the commissioner to arrest peoples. Now, this section, again, you read it very carefully. Don't worry about what the decision has come from Supreme Court, High Court, etc. Judgment always come and go. You can make a better judgment always. Because some point, if it is not discussed and not brought to the notice of the court, it was never argued. So you cannot have a better judgment. Therefore, what the this four-line section, there are so many, you know, condition has been put on the commissioner. First thing is that the commissioner has reason to believe. And I need not to explain it. because the chartered accountant by and large understand this concept region to region. I have been told now, probably this word has been removed now from section 147, 148 in 2021. But anyway, it has been in existence since beginning and large number of judgments are there. What is the point I am trying to make it here? That you have to understand. If you compare it reason to believe with the Indian Penal Code law, CRPC, in the criminal cases, the police will not arrest you on the cases of reason to believe. Police will not register a case on the basis of reason to believe. They registered a case merely on the complaint. If today you lodge a complaint, my mobile has been stolen or snatched away, then a cognizable offense you are reporting, a police is bound to register a complaint and start making investigation. Therefore, merely because you have a suspicious and suspect, still a criminal, law come into motion. But these kind of the law will not come into the motion merely because you have some suspicious things in your mind. It come into the play when you have a reason to believe. That means the three things. First things, you have a documents. Secondly, you have apply your mind on those documents. The third, you have recorded your finding, maybe as brief as possible, but which is discernible from that finding that you have applied your mind. Then only you can act upon under this section. And this power is given to the commissioner, not below the rank of the commissioner. Therefore, the second point which we have to understand, that the commissioner is not a rubber stamp of his subordinate officers. And you will laugh to know it. And that's why I stopped going to the department as soon as I become aware of it. Once you go to the court, you will find different things. Whether you are happy with the court decision or not, that is a different thing. But in the court, every judge opens the file himself. Every judge hear your, argument himself. Every judge dictate the decision himself. Every judge put a signature on his own document himself. Every judge read his own judgment himself and then put a signature. But in department, everything is done by the subordinate officers. And the commissioner or the senior officer become just like a puppet. They simply put the signature. That is not envisaged in the law. If the law says commissioner has reason to believe, every word is important. I'm going a little fast because of the time paucity. I remember Mr. Saket told me 1.5 hours we will give the time and 1.5 hours, we'll keep it, for the question answer. But it depends upon you. Whenever, you will just ring the bell, I will stop it. Because time is always, important. I will never say one can go on and go on, because there is a capacity to learn also for everybody. We can't put overdose for anything. So therefore, if we learn the word, the commissioner has reason to believe. That means who has to reason to believe? He himself. If his subordinate officer has reason to believe and he has put a signature, that is illegal. And I can show you those judgments. Therefore, you can't act as a rubber stamp opinion of the somebody else. And something may be new to those who are practicing under the income tax law also. Because as you go in detail about that, because the income tax law is a very soft law. You are not afraid of it. I never heard somebody has been arrested under income tax law, despite a lot of black money. We are hearing entire throughout my life with a black money snatch outside India, but never arrested even a single person. So it is so simple and so lazy and so, luxurious law. You can evade taxes, you can have a black money, still no threat of arrest. So who will afraid of that law? So you will not read that law in that much depth because there is no requirement. If no arrest is happening, why I will get expertise in the income tax law or for arrest provisions? Even the summons were the very rarest. Now, after Narendra Modi, government has come, I think it has become most, prevalent. Otherwise, I never heard the summon has been issued under income tax law. So therefore, their understanding is little different. So therefore, this is important. Who has to form an opinion? Then, another word, the person has committed offense. Committed. Not merely suspicious things. Committed. Like if suppose somebody can be arrested if a murder has been committed. Attempt to murder is different than murder committed is totally different. Therefore, the offense has committed. If he suspect that the offense maybe may not be, no, has committed means, yes, I remember it. In fact, the Madras High Court in one case, name I just forget, in GST law said, committed means what? It has already happened. If it is not has happened, then how you can exercise your power? And then through the offense is limited to the ABCD, which I will not go in detail about that. That is not our topic of the day today. And that what he has to do, he has to pass order. By order, every word of the law is important. Only thing we chartered accountant must understand. Ki every word in the law is important. Even a comma full stop become important. I can remember when I was in the seventh class, my English teacher wrote a sentence on the blackboard and wrote the same sentence twice. Just he shifted a comma from one place to another place. The sentence was that roko comma mat jane do. Second sentence was the roko mat jane do. And you can understand the meaning. Roko mat jane do. Stop him. Not allow him to go. Roko mat jane do. Don't stop him. Let him go. Because you shift a comma from one place to another place in the same sentence, the meaning has undergone significant change. It is diagonally opposite to the what we had told in the first sentence. Therefore, here also, every word of the law is important. There are Supreme Court judgment to this effect. You can't say that any words is superfluous in the law. You can't assume that this word has no importance. Therefore, if he has not passed any order in his file, then his arrest order is also illegal. And by that order, he will authorize any central of any officer of the central tax. Here, the word is totally different. Any officer of central tax. And in the previous section, we have seen the proper officer. Therefore, you may be the central tax officer. You may not be the proper officer. You may be the central tax officer. You may be the proper officer, but you may not be the inquiry conducting proper officers. Each section, different terminology, the meaning undergo change. The commissioner can authorize any central tax officer to arrest, but there are certain safeguards. The parliament has made it under these provisions, but these are taken to the bay in practical life. If you challenge and the court is very serious with call to the file, you will see that most of the arrests are illegal. But only thing is that if you go to the lower court domain is very limited. But if you go to the high court, then the law undergone significant change. And let's see this couple of judgments. You know, this is the Gujarat High Court judgment. And I've given the gist of this judgment in this one slide. And this judgment, to my mind, is not correct in the law. Because the judgment say, first, the arrest could be made without even adjudications, without even assessment done. Though in one way, understanding is correct. But the EB judgment, which I succeed before Delhi High Court approved by the Supreme Court, it was stated that unless a so-called notice is issued, order is passed, you can't make arrest unless a person is habitual offender. Second thing is that in this judgment, the High Court, Gujarat High Court said section 154 to 157 of CRPC is not applicable. I will tell you in the simple word, because we are not familiar with all this CRPC provision, etc. What does it mean? Whether before arrest is made, FIR is required to be registered or not. And High Court held, Gujarat High Court in this case, that it is not required. And I will give you the contrary decision. I will give you the contrary decision of the Bombay High Court also. Though it is of the GST law, that is the custom law. But this judgment is also based upon a custom decisions and so many other decisions also. Therefore, next, he is not a police officer. the you know, the central tax officer not obliged to register an FIR. And then they says there is no formal acquisition of offences required to be made. Whether this judgment is correct or not, then the another judgment will come, and then you will see. Let go on and to find out what the other cases are saying. The Supreme Court judgment, Constitution Bench judgment in this A.R. Antule case says, if there is in a special law no procedure is prescribed, then the procedure prescribed under the CRPC will be applicable. Therefore, if the GST law does not prescribe any procedure for arresting, when is to be arrested, who will investigate, which rank of the officer, what shall be the procedure for investigation, if GST law is not prescribed, then every procedure prescribed under the criminal law, criminal code of procedure law, CRPC, all such procedures shall be applicable. And that procedure says, unless the FIR is registered, no arrest could be made. Unless, you know, the person is appearing and cooperating before the investigation officer, he cannot be arrested. If the total punishment, you know, maximum punishment under the law is less than 7 years or up to 7 years. GST law does not prescribe punishment more than 7 years. It is below 7 years, up to 5 years. Therefore, arrest could not have been made. These are the procedure prescribed, because this judgment has never been quoted and discussed in the judgment of the Gujarat High Court. Similarly, in the Om Prakash judgment of the Supreme Court, I was just quoting a couple of minutes back, the similar plea was taken. And in fact, the government advocates, Mr. Mohan Prasaran, learned additional solicitor general, he himself said before the Supreme Court, I quote him, which is recorded in para 18 of this judgment, the what point to be considered in the writ petition was whether there is a power to arrest vested in the officer exercise power under Section 13 of the Central Excise Act of 1944 without issuance of a warrant, or whether such power could be also exercised only after an FIR or a complaint lodged under Section 13. However, this point was argued. The Supreme Court did not decide this point, because the Supreme Court said every offense is non-cognizable. Therefore, this point was in the earlier law was also quite open for debate. And I have been told, though I am not arguing any of the case, there are certain cases in the Supreme Court are pending of the GST, of the PMLA, and various other acts which have been combined together. Whether FIR is first required to be registered or first arrest can be made, that is the point still open. Therefore, these are the points still has to be considered. Don't take one judgment which is against you is a fit judgment. This the judgment may be well known to the Dr. Pratap Singh under the FERA, where it was says reason to believe is totally different than the reason to suspect. Therefore, you cannot substitute the word reason to believe in Section 69 as the reason to suspect. If the commissioner has a reason to suspect, he cannot make any arrest. If he has a reason to believe, he can order for the arrest. And that difference one has to point out, and on the basis of that, you can fight your case. And that is the J. Sekhar case. It is wrongly written, the Sekhar case, the J. Sekhar case. In this case, what the Delhi High Court said, I just already told, and I will not repeat again. You can read this, that one person cannot be a rubber stamp of the another person. If the law has cast a responsibility, you form an opinion, you have to form an opinion. If it is cast a responsibility upon me to form an opinion, I have to form an opinion. I just cannot be a signatory to the opinion formed by others. Then the another two judgment I have, you know, put it before you of the Supreme Court. Very interesting what the Supreme Court said, and that these judgment you can, these could be very helpful to fight the GST cases as well, which are related to this fake invoices or any other severe or heinous, you know, offenses under which they are booking it. Howsoever strong may be the suspicions of the court in this connection, it cannot take place of proof. If you can remember in the beginning, I told you that the commissioner has to produce an evidence if he is making an allegation that there was no supply of goods. And onus is on the commissioner, not on you. Therefore, if he is saying that there was no supply of goods, he may be having doubt But doubt cannot be converted into a proof. Proof required a proof. If he is collecting a tax, you can prove it. He has collected the tax, therefore there was a supply of goods. But he is saying there was no supply of goods, then he has to bring an evidence. And the court will ask a counter question. If you are, there was no supply, why you collected tax? Why you ask him to pay the tax without a credit, taking credit? If without taking credit, if he pay the tax, it become a supply. As soon as he take a credit, it become a no supply. What funny the argument is, therefore, suspicious, howsoever great grave it may be, it cannot take the place of a proof. And proof, you are not required to. In fact, the certain clients who come to me with along with their chartered accountant, they always said, कि आप प्रूफ कहां से लाएंगे, इसको प्रूफ कैसे करेंगे? मैंने कहा प्रूफ मेरे को थोड़ी करना है भाई, प्रूफ उसको करना है जो एलिगेशन लगा रहा है। मैं तो इतना ही अपने मन के सेटिस्फेक्शन के लिए प्रूफ करता हूं कि आपके पास बिल है, आपने टैक्स दिया है, आपने अपनी बुक्स ऑफ अकाउंट्स में रिकॉर्ड किया है। जब वो तीनों के आंसर हाँ में दे देता है तो मैं कहता हूं बस अब आप रेस्ट करें, आराम की नींद सोएं, ऑफिसर्स को हम देख लें, और इससे बड़ा एविडेंस आप क्या ला सकते हैं? और कुछ नहीं ला सकते। आज आपके पास एक लैपटॉप रखा हुआ है जिस पे वेबिनार सुन रहे हो, ये सम ऑफिसर कम एंड से दैट नो 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 ये चोरी का है, तो आप क्या प्रूव करेंगे? आप बिली तो दिखा सकते हैं, आप हनुमान जी तो है नहीं, अपना छीना फाड़ के दिखाएंगे। आपके पास बिल है तो वो इंक्वायरी वो करेगा ना, वो तो इसलिए एकदम कहता है अरेस्ट कर लूंगा ताकि आप डर जाए उसके पैर पकड़ें। जितना डर आपको लगता है उससे 100 गुना डर उस झूठ बोलने वाले ऑफिसर को लगता है। एक बार टेस्ट करके देखो, टेस्ट करके देखो। मैंने तो लाइफ में बचपन से आज तक बहुत बार किया है। जैसे ही आपका कॉन्फिडेंस बोलता है ना तो ऑफिसर हिलने लग जाता है। आप एक बार उसको बोलो अभी आपकी ये कंप्लेंट करने वाला हूं। अभी थोड़े दिन पहले जीएसटी का एक केस हुआ, मैंने केस सक्सीड किया 2020 10th जून को शायद फाइनल जजमेंट आया, एंड दिल्ली हाई कोर्ट रोट एंड दैट जजमेंट्स दिस द फ्रिवलस केस इज बीइंग मेड आउट बाय द जीएसटी ऑफिसर्स एंड दे डायरेक्ट माय इन माय पिटिशंस टू रिफंड द एंटायर अमाउंट विद 6% इंटरेस्ट एंड दैट वाज द केस लॉन्ग टाइम वाज बुक बट बाय व्हाट वाज हैंडल्ड बाय द जीएसटी ऑफिसर्स And for last 16 year or so, interest was granted to my client. And 25,000 rupees penalty was also imposed on those officers. And once my junior was in the department, and he told my guru is J.K. Mittal. And he called me, उस officer के tone change हो गए। बोला भाई मित्तल साहब का फोन मत करिए, आप जो कहते हो वैसे ही केस में कर देंगे। क्योंकि उसको समझ आ गया मैं केस गलत कर रहा हूं, तो मित्तल साहब के पास केस चला जाएगा, कोर्ट में चला जाएगा और मेरे ऊपर एक्शन हो जाएगा। तो यू हैव टू क्रिएट एन इंप्रेशन ऑफ यू नो इन द माइंड द ऑफिसर आल्सो, इफ यू अब्यूज द पावर लॉ विल टेक केयर। इफ लॉ कैन टेक केयर ए क्लाइंट, लॉ कैन टेक केयर द क्लाइंट ऑफ द करप्ट ऑफिसर्स आल्सो। इफ यू अंडरस्टैंड द लॉ इन दिस वे, आई एम श्योर यू विल गेट सक्सेस। This is the contrary, this is Adani Enterprises judgment, if you read it. This is from Bombay High Court of the Custom Act, which is parametrial to the similar provision which we have read of the GST law. And Bombay High Court clearly said the section 154, 155 of the CRPC will be applicable if you want to make any arrest. Therefore, without FIR, you can't arrest a person, and if it is a non-cognizable offense, you have to take a warrant from the court, and only then you can arrest a person. And in Arnesh Kumar judgment, they clearly said, first you satisfied arrest is legal or not, then only you can send somebody in the, you know, judicial custody. Therefore, there are judgments, though, because initially, you know, arrest has been made throughout the country. One adverse judgment came from, you know, in a different context from Telangana High Court. And because of that, you know, everybody understands the law in a different fashion. That is not our job. If you lose one assessment case, that does not mean you will stop practicing from today onwards. You continue to practice. and you still succeed in large number of cases. Therefore, if you are not able to convince to the judges, or if judges are not able, you know, to understand and appreciate the point, and if a judgment has come, that judgment will not become a law like that it can never be changed. You still continue to have and believe on yourself, you will get the better judgment. Let's, you know, leave the this topic here and move on to the next topic. And this topic is, you know, denial of input tax credit to the buyers. And this denial is, you know, very interesting, because now the decision has come from Madras High Court, and earlier decision from Delhi High Court and Punjab and Haryana High Court under the VAT law on the similar situation. Now the question arises is, suppose the today I or you purchase certain goods, you paid the tax to your vendor. There could be three, four situations. Either vendor has not filed the return, he might have paid the tax. Second, he even might not have paid the tax also. And third is the worst situation. He may not in existence. He might have died. He might have closed his business. He might have committed a fraud and run away from this country. The question is that, because of that, can I be punished? Answer is no. The law has not cast any responsibility upon you. And the law is very simple to understand. The law is simple to understand that if the law is made in such a fashion which has cast any responsibility upon you, over which you have no control, then you cannot fulfill that condition at all. Impossibility of performance. I am sure you can remember your CA intermediate, you know, study materials. Therefore, if your purchase is, you know, correct, you paid the tax, you recorded in the books of accounts, because of the fault committed or the offense committed by the vendor, the buyer cannot be punished. That is the law. Despite that, you have the certain provision in the GST law, you will not be entitled to take credit if the vendor has not filed the return. You will not be entitled to take a credit if you have, the vendor has not paid the tax. Despite that, you are entitled to take a credit. That is the things we have to understand. Because the law itself is faulty. How you can cast a burden on me? I paid the money and you recover it to me, and your notice says vendor has not paid the tax. You understand this concept is a simple word. If their notice says vendor has not paid the tax, then why not is he issuing summon to the vendor? Why is not issuing a notice to the vendor? Why is not booking to the vendor? Because the vendor pay in the money. जो fraud करते हैं वो तो पैसा दे देंगे officers को, और officer ऐसा ही law बनाना चाहता है कि मैं fraud करने वाले से तो पैसा लेके छोड़ दूं, और जिसने fraud नहीं किया है उसको पकड़ लूं और उसकी life hell कर दूं. इस law की foundation ही मेरे को wrong लगती है. I can share with you, and today is the occasion to share my memory way back to the 2003. When I was addressing a conference of the chartered accountant in 2003, that time a similar provision was made in the services credit rule 2002. Jin logo ko nahi pata hai, they can go back and find out. Sandwich credit rule aane se pehle, services credit rules the 2002 mein, usme amendment hoke 2003 mein hua, phir sandwich credit rule 2004 mein aaye, jisme excise aur services ke rule merge ki. जब 2003 the law was amended and a law was made, your credit will be denied if we will find that the vendor has not paid the tax, and we will recover it from you, that credit along with an interest. I said I am sorry. How you can make that law? Fortunately, I can remember that time service tax member service act from the board was with me on the dais. I told him, sir, I can't understand the validity of this law. Your law itself says if the vendor has not deposited the tax, then who debar you to collect it from the vendor? Why you will collect it from the buyer? If in simple word I tell you, if the police says X has committed a, you know, the crime, but we will arrest you, who will recognize this law? Nobody will recognize this law. But fortunately or unfortunately, such practice started in the VAT regime. They thought it to put it into the GST regime, and you know, maybe not in very serious tone, and it may be very serious thought to consider it. Why this law was allowed to be continued? I have a serious doubt on the conduct those who make such kind of a law, because the law drafting is done by the officers in the parliament, just pass it. Because the parliamentarians are not supposed to know the technicality of the law. Therefore, you see these three judgments and you will find, you know, a laughing stone before you. On Quest judgment from Delhi High Court. Another judgment is Gerulal Balchan judgment from Punjab Haryana High Court. These are the VAT judgments, and clearly said you can't recover anything from the buyer. You go to the vendor. Buyer can only be held responsible if the officer is able to prove that there is a connivance between buyer and seller. Both want to deceive and cheat to the government and exchequer. Then only you can held responsible buyer. Otherwise, buyer is not responsible. And this GST judgment you see of the recent judgment of February 2021 of the Madras High Court clearly wrote, para 16, para 13. Para 13 is very serious. He said, I am unable to appreciate the approach of the authorities. When it come out that the seller has collected tax from the purchasing dealer, the omission on the part of the seller to remit the question is must have been viewed very seriously, and strict action ought to have been initiated against him. Therefore, law says if the seller has committed an offense, seller has committed a fault not depositing the tax, you should take action, serious action against the vendor only, not to come to the buyer. जो फ्रॉड करने वाला है उसको कवर दे रहे हैं आप इस सेक्शन में, और जो शरीफ आदमी है उसको आप बेईमान ठहरा के उसकी दुकान बंद करवा रहे हैं. You ask any officer if he can justify this law. वो सिंपली आपको एक आंसर कहेंगे, मैं क्या कर सकता हूं, ये तो कानून में लिखा हुआ है. ये आंसर नहीं होता एक ऑनेस्ट ऑफिसर्स का. He is a guardian of the government fund. He should make the law as simple as possible, as rational as possible. If we start making such kind of a law, who will conduct a business in this country? Bank attachment, very interesting subject. And I will take not much time. I have one slide to show you. I have many slides, but one slide will sum up many things about the bank attachment. This is another tool in the hands of the officers. Nowadays, they attach bank account of every company, company's director, OD account, CC account, wife account, partner account, children accounts. I was hearing the another case, 150 accounts of a person was attached by the officers. Law does not permit like this. इनको होलसेल में पावर नहीं है ऑफिसर्स को. वो इस्तेमाल करते हैं, क्योंकि पिछले दो चार साल में 40-50 ऑफिसर्स को मैंने सुना कि इस गवर्नमेंट ने सस्पेंड किया या निकाला या डिसमिस किया या वॉलंटरी रिटायरमेंट भी आप कह लो. मेरे को तो लगता है पूरी की पूरी टीम ही बदलने का समय आ गया. ऑनेस्टी तो देखने को ही नहीं मिलती. वो समझते हैं कि लॉ में एक अटैचमेंट लिख गया तो किसी की और कभी कर लेते हैं. वो सारे वर्ड लिखे हैं. तो दीज आर द क्वेश्चन वी शुड डिस्कस एंड आई एम डिस्कसिंग विद यू. इज द अटैचमेंट ऑफ द बैंक अकाउंट कैन बी डन ऑफ अनदर पर्सन व्हेन द प्रोसीडिंग ऑफ द पेंडिंग फॉर द डिफरेंट पर्सन. मीनिंग देयर वाइज सपोज ए कंपनी इज बीइंग इन्वेस्टिगेटेड, वेदर द बैंक अकाउंट ऑफ द बी कंपनी कैन बी अटैच्ड, आंसर इज नो. Attachment of the bank account only could be done of a company against whom the proceeding has been initiated. not of the subsidiary company, holding company, relative company, relative account, father account, mother account. No, it is not permissible. Second, when the search is end, whether the proceeding for attachment is permissible, answer is no. As of now, before 2021 amendment, there was a limited, you know, the power was given. If the proceeding is pending under the following section, like one of that section was the search proceeding going on under section 67(2). The proceeding going on, the matlab, when the you are making a search, as soon as you concluded the search, your power also come to an end under this provisions. The third, whether second time attachment is possible. What second time attachment? You understand this provision will help you to understand the not only this provision, to many other provisions also. Because the law says your attachment can continue maximum for 1 year period. What the officer does it? They make attachments, and after making an attachments, once 1 year is expired, the same day they will send two letters to the bank. One letter, we are lifting the attachment. Another letter, that reattachment. That means effectively attachment was continued. Law does not permit it. You can't extend the time which the parliament does not permit you. Second time attachment of the same case, same client in similar situation cannot continue. If it has come to an end, it will come to an end. Another point, the power has been given to the commissioner. Whether the commissioner can delegate that power, yes, under section 5(3), that power can be delegated. Therefore, you must understand, wherever it is written, the power assigned to the commissioner, at the same time, the power can be delegated. Now, the question will be raised, who is serious under the power of arrest? To my mind, that cannot be done. Here, the question was little different, where the court has accepted this. Next, whether the hearing of the objection is necessary, the Supreme Court answered, yes, it is necessary. These all questions have been answered in the Radha Krishna judgment of 2021 April by the Supreme Court only. Whether the formation of the opinion of some tangible material is necessary, yes, it is necessary. Whether the order passed by the state commissioner is appealable, answer is no. You must understand this. This is very important. And this has changed the entire scenario of the entire case. The appeal can be filed under section 107 against the order passed by the adjudicating authority. Now, if the joint commissioner, deputy commissioner, assistant commissioner, if they pass an order, whether that against that order appeal can be filed or not. Supreme Court said no appeal can be filed. Only writ petition can be filed. Why? Because the law, GST law, though it is said it is uniform law, it is not uniform. Central GST and state GST, many provisions are different. And one of the different is definition of adjudicating authority. State law says adjudicating authority does not include commissioner. Para 62 of this judgment on the US screen. Therefore, the Supreme Court said if the joint commissioner passes an order, it will be treated as the order passed by a commissioner only. Because the commissioner has given his power to delegate, and therefore the commissioner is not including in the power of the adjudicating authority. Therefore, such an order is not appealable. You have to go into the writ petition only. Therefore, these were the questions which were answered. Is that the time is not permitting to go on these details. Let's, Mr. Saket can permit me, we have 15 minutes, if I can cover very, very briefly, you know, the sum of the points. One is the on the spot, whether payment of tax can be collected or not. Answer is simply no. No officer has the power while conducting a search or a seizure to force any client to pay any amount of tax, whatsoever may be the reason, whatsoever may be the evidence, whatsoever may be the suspicious he has in his mind, that power not in existence in the law. Case which I am fighting, the nearest cement before Gujarat High Court, but there are already the final two judgment under the different law, Central Excise and VAT law of Delhi High Court, which is on your screen. You can read it. I will not go much in detail because the time will not permit us. Another is whether there could be multiple authority under the GST can go on. Multiple means the center and the state, they are sending notices and the summons to the same assessee. That is not envisaged under the GST law. In fact, this circular of the GST council says there should be single interface. Either central or the state officer will make an assessment, will make an inquiry about both the laws. But in practice, this is not happening. Overlapping jurisdiction is not permissible. The law is settled. If even if there is an overlapping, you know, decision, the first who exercises the power, he has to conduct not all the offices together and simultaneously or one after another. The three judgment I told you, NBCC and EB's, I have found it. Canon judgment, etc. You can read it. That can save you. Another is the whether center and state both can exercise. In the coin judgment, I took a stay. And after granting a stay, now the summon has been withdrawn in the last 20th July only. Once you take to the court and you raise these points, the summons were also withdrawn. Similarly, Calcutta High Court granted a stay with both center and state are doing simultaneously the GST proceeding. They said it is not permissible under the law. That is the law. Next point is about the proper officer. I have already discussed, but it has a greater significance because the proper officer means only the one proper officer. Therefore, you can make out the another case that the proper officer, if used under section 73, 74, under section 70 and various other provision, whether he is the one very officer or the different officer, answer you can find out. But very important factor, I want to discuss it here. Sometime you will find in the central GST law, your jurisdictional officer will conduct a proceeding and then DGGI, which earlier known as DGCI, those officers will also conduct a proceeding. In that case, the judgment will help you, the Canon India. Canon India said the law does not recognize these things. You can have a multiple, you know, the officers investigating the same assessee for the same issue and same period. That reopening by the different officer at the different level is not permissible in the law. You just can go and read those judgments. Next is the departmental audit. This is a very, you know, interesting issue, though time is not permitting, but still I will give you the two, three major points. If you read this section, it is a plain section, a blunt section. It does not give any safeguard. It does not give any reason why the audit need to be conducted. It says commissioner or any officer authorized by him, either by general or special order, may undertake audit of any registered premises. What does it mean? Anytime, any officers can conduct audit of any assessee. Then what is the use of self-assessment? If you have seen, if a summons shall be issued, various safeguard. If a search will be made, various safeguard. Arrest would be made, various safeguard. Audit will be conducted anytime by any officers authorized, either general or by a special order, can be conducted. Therefore, such provision can be challenged in the court. Second is the procedure. If they are not following the procedure, you always can fight with them. You always respond back to them. They are not supposed to sit in your premises for forever and to make assessment of whatever things. In fact, you must insist upon, which this government has made it mandatory long time back, even before GST law was starting. If the departmental officer conduct an audit, they are bound to give you the audit report, even if it is a nil audit report. Otherwise, in subsequent proceeding, they will say, no. If audit was conducted and he did not check it at all, if he did not check it, it is his responsibility. Therefore, the audit is a significant part. You only can quote one judgment of, the Supreme Court. That is the Sara India judgment. that is the income tax decision. And Supreme Court beautifully write, if the departmental officer will conduct an audit, which is the special audit under income tax law, that time thereafter one section 142, 1A or something was also amended. Even if the law does not say anything, it is implicit. You have to give the notice by giving the reason why the audit need to be conducted. And the assessee has a right to contest that because the audit has a civil consequences. Therefore, it burden cannot be cast upon the, you know, the audit assessee. He has to mandatorily undergo the audit. If you feel the audit is not your interest, you can challenge it. Just 5 minutes more. Then mandatory mention of the document identification number. We have already discussed the DIN number is now has been made mandatory. You read those circular very carefully. Even the communication made by email has also come under the compulsory DIN number. Therefore, don't entertain those emails. And this circular is very clear saying, if any communication has come without quoting a DIN number, that will be treated as invalid, has never been issued at all. Therefore, you are not supposed to respond to those communications. The last point is very, very interesting. It is the amendment which has come. Already there was too much power with the officers, but the power hungerness has not left the officers. They need more power. And that is the section 151 has been amended, and which is very draconian. If you read, this section is very short. It says, commissioner or an officer authorized by him may by an order direct any person to furnish information relating to any matter dealt within connection with this act within such time and in such form and such manner as may be specified. No safeguard, no limitation, no embargo. Anytime they can ask about any matter dealt under this act, you have to provide information. And they can ask, you know, furnish information to any matters, no limitation of information. These kind of section, to my mind, is invalid under the law. A point will come when the people like me will challenge these provision in the court of law. Because they also simultaneously amended section 167 or 168, where 151 was, you know, correlated with that. But now this power has been translated or given to the downward to the commissioner at the department level, not the commissioner in custom. This is the most draconian provision which I have never seen in the life. You read any law that you will give the hand-free power to a commissioner anytime he can use against anyone without having any limitation. I have wrote letter even to the finance minister and the prime minister about this section. This should not be rolled out because kai bar kehte hai na ki koi law bekar kaise ho jata hai. I just want to conclude by giving one example. Everybody has a knife in his house. How you use it, it will depend upon that. If you use it as a cutter in your kitchen, it becomes a very useful tool. If you use it as a weapon to pour it in the body of somebody else, it becomes a misuse. Therefore, whether it is a Dogri Act, whether it is a Domestic Violation Act, whether it is a SCSC Act, if you read the Supreme Court thinking now, Supreme Court said these are the most abused law. The people are being arrested for vested interest. Every law which gives the power, unlimited power, are prone to be abused, which at point of time when you start it appears to be a good law, but it's proved to be bad law because we do not know how to use this law except for the vested interest. Thank you very much. I have exceeded my time limit and some of the topic I have not gone into detail, but I'm sure I would have justified. It will depend upon your feedback and your question answer. Thank you so much. I'm stop sharing my screen now. Thank you.
Sir, it was a mesmerizing as usual, as expected. It was so, so mesmerizing, sir. ऐसे लगता है कि सेशन चलते रहे से इट्स ऑलवेज प्लेजर टू हियर यू यानी पता ही नहीं चलता टाइम कितना हो रहा है और एक और ही होता है सर आपकी जब भी सुनते हैं तो जितने चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट्स होंगे जितने टैक्स प्रैक्टिशनर्स होंगे उनका एक पैटर्न तो चेंज हो जाएगा प्रैक्टिस का फ्रॉम डिफेंसिव स्टाइल ऑफ प्रैक्टिसिंग दे बिकम्स एन एग्रेसिव स्टाइल ऑफ प्रैक्टिस नॉर्मली फॉलो करने लगेंगे Yeah, one thing is very sure, law take care of every corrupt practices, and power of hungerness is always there. There is always a difference between what the government is thinking and what the officer is thinking. And it's a practice of making a complaint, raising an issue, fighting for it. That makes a difference, because jitna aadmi taxpayer darta hai, usse jyada to officers darte hai. But it need to be taken up very strongly. You know? The session is now open for the question and answers. Anyone who want to raise a question, want to put a question, can just raise their hands. Sir, chat box mein ek do query aayi hai.
If you can read it for me, I will answer.
Yes. Sir, first question hai. The department contains the commitment of the following offenses. Section 122, Roman 2, issues any invoice or bill without supply of goods or service, or both, in violation of the provision of this act or rules made thereunder. Section 122, Roman 6, takes or utilizes ITC without actual receipts of goods or services, or both, either fully or partially, in contravention of the provision of this act or rules made thereunder. Question is,
yes, what is exactly the question then?
Actually, the question is, there is no question. Actually, it's just a sharing of information, I think. Section 122, Roman 2 and Roman 6. I think it's just information sharing is there. He's there, the queries is there.
Because section 122 related to the imposition of penalty. And, yeah. You know, section 122 penalty once will be imposed, if, as I told you, if they have the power to issue a show cause notice. And after the show cause notice, you have the power to contest it. And while you contest it, you will use your power to examination and cross-examination of the officers and the witnesses also. That skill one must have it. Because, and secondly, the evidence has to be produced by the officers only. Let me share, you know, one thing, a similar kind of offense I am dealing with the central excise right now. It's the 500 crore rupees demand is there. When I went to the bottom of that, one example I'm giving, I have unearthed, you know, maybe more than 100 such example in that very case only. They one asked the two bill of 2003 to make out their case in favor of the department. And I found that the TIN number is mentioned on those invoices. It came in my mind that TIN number is related to the VAT, and VAT itself was started from 1st April 2005. How could be an existence of the TIN number on these invoices? Therefore, I went to the website and I checked it, and I found that this TIN number was issued in 2007 and those were put in 2003 bill. That means these are the bogus bill which have been supported by the department. Therefore, if penalty proceeding has been initiated, you have a right to defend it. And onus is on the department. Department will not be able to prove those evidences, then you will win that case. If the department bring the evidence, you have to read it carefully. You cross-examine those officers and you can make out a case in your favor.
Sir, a query is from, another query is from Rajesh Sharma.
Yes.
Rajuji, you can unmute.
Yes, sir. Pranam, sir. C.A. Rajiv Sharma here. सर yes. धन्यवाद, आपके बहुत अच्छा सेशन होता है हमेशा. सर मेरी सर एक लिमिटेड क्वेरी थी कि जो बर्डन ऑफ प्रूफ अंडर सेक्शन 155 कंटेस्ट किया जाता है डिपार्टमेंट की तरफ से, कि इफ यू क्लेम दैट यू आर एलिजिबल फॉर इनपुट टैक्स क्रेडिट देन बर्डन ऑफ प्रूविंग सच क्लेम शैल लाई ऑन सच पर्सन.
यस,
इसको ये एडिशन में करते हैं कि जो आपने फेक बिलिंग में ये कहते हैं कि आपने बिल तो लिया है लेकिन सामान आपकी तरफ सप्लाई नहीं हुआ, उनपे चार्ज ये किया जाता है कि आपने बिल रेज करा है लेकिन सप्लाई नहीं दी है. साथ में ये 155 का बर्डन ऑफ प्रूफ का वो एक अम्ब्रेला के अंदर कहते हैं कि आप प्रूफ करिए. सर यहाँ पर कैसे कंटेस्ट किया जा सकता है, इस 155 का स्पेसिफिक इम्प्लीकेशन हमारे लिए क्या हो सकता है?
बर्डन ऑफ प्रूफ आपके ऊपर है, आप क्या प्रूफ करेंगे उस टाइम? उस टाइम आप बिल प्रूफ करेंगे, आप पेमेंट दे रही है यही प्रूव कर सकते हैं. आप गुड्स को थोड़ी सारी जिंदगी अपने पास रखेंगे. द बर्डन ऑफ प्रूफ ऑन यू डज नॉट मीन्स कि यू हैव टू कीप दिस गुड्स विद यू ऑलवेज अंटिल द कमिश्नर विल कम and he will make a case against you. So you have discharged your burden. Every burden has a his own limitation. अगर आज आप मैंने रसगुल्ले मंगाए हैं घर में और रसगुल्ले खाए हैं, मैंने जीएसटी पे कर दिया और वो बिल रखा हुआ है, अब कमिश्नर का ये प्रूव करे कि रसगुल्ले आए थे या नहीं आए थे, अब उन रसगुल्लों को कमिश्नर के लिए तो मैं रखूंगा नहीं। तो कोर्ट जब आप बर्डन ऑफ प्रूफ की बात करते हैं, अगर आपके पास बिल भी नहीं है, आपके पास एंट्री भी नहीं है, तो आप बर्डन ऑफ प्रूफ नहीं कर पाएंगे। आप क्या स्टॉक रजिस्टर में अपनी एंट्री दिखाएंगे, आप प्रोडक्शन दिखाएंगे उस गुड्स का आपने प्रोड्यूस किया है, तो ये सारी चीजें होती है, आप सेल दिखाएंगे, तो ये सारी चीजें कि आपके पास गुड्स आया है, अदरवाइज कैसे बन गया गुड्स। गुड्स का फिजिकल नहीं दिखा सकते आप उस टाइम, तो जो रीजनेबल एक्सपेक्टेशन रहती है प्रूफ की वही रहती है। इसका मतलब ये नहीं है कि प्रूफ करके वो चीज दिखाएंगे जो एग्जिस्टेंस में उस टाइम रहेगी नहीं, तो ये इसका मीनिंग मैं समझता हूं। बाकी जब प्रैक्टिकल केस को करते हैं, अगर हमारे पास ये केस जब आएंगे तो उस पर और इन्वेस्टिगेशन करके और कोई डिबेट कर सकते हैं, मेरे को लगता है इससे बियॉन्ड आपके पास बर्डन ऑफ प्रूफ का और कोई चीज आ नहीं सकती।
क्योंकि सर डिपार्टमेंट मैक्सिमम एक स्टेटमेंट ऑफ द अदर पार्टी जो हमारे सप्लायर्स हैं उनकी स्टेटमेंट होती है कि हमने गुड सप्लाई नहीं करी, हमने सिर्फ बिल्स इशू करे हैं। कई बार वो भी ड्यू टू डर अरेस्ट के डर से भी स्टेटमेंट दे देते हैं, तो यहाँ पर ये प्रॉब्लम। ठीक है, आपकी बात की
बहुत ही अच्छा क्वेश्चन आपने पूछा है, लेट मी एक्सप्लेन इट टू यू एंड इट विल बेनिफिट एवरी चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट, बिकॉज वन लिमिटेशन चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट हैज and that will always be there because we have not been acquainted with the court proceedings.
जी
हम समझ लेते हैं कि किसी की स्टेटमेंट आ गई तो वो एविडेंस हो गया। स्टेटमेंट इज नॉट एन एविडेंस एट ऑल, स्टेटमेंट इज वन ऑफ दैट लिंक टू रीच टू दैट। जब स्टेटमेंट रिकॉर्ड की जाती है वो एविडेंस कब बनती है, हमें ये पॉइंट समझना है। इसमें पंजाब हरियाणा हाईकोर्ट का ब्यूटीफुल जजमेंट है, दिल्ली हाईकोर्ट का है, इलाहाबाद हाईकोर्ट के हैं, अगर आप पढ़ेंगे, जब उसने स्टेटमेंट रिकॉर्ड की वो एविडेंस नहीं है। जब एडजुडिकेशन होता है दैट स्टेटमेंट हैज टू बी री रिकॉर्डेड दैट टाइम एंड वंस ही विल बी एग्जामिन्ड, तो उसको डिपार्टमेंट को उसको एविडेंस के रूप में लाना पड़ेगा एडजुडिकेटिंग अथॉरिटी के पास या कोर्ट में जब क्रिमिनल प्रोसीडिंग चलेगी। अगर वो लेके ही नहीं आते उसको तो वो एविडेंस ही नहीं माना जाएगा, पहली बात, वो स्टेटमेंट एक कागज का टुकड़ा बन के रह जाएगा। सेकेंडली, जब वो उसको लेके आएंगे तो आपका राइट है क्रॉस एग्जामिन करने का, इफ दे एग्जामिन देन यू विल क्रॉस एग्जामिन हिम। जब आप क्रॉस एग्जामिन करेंगे तो आप उसको झूठा प्रूव कर देंगे। आपको सिंपल एग्जांपल देता हूं कि सपोज मैंने किसी से गुड्स परचेज किया और उसने स्टेटमेंट दे दी कि मैंने तो गुड्स सप्लाई नहीं किया, यही तो स्टेटमेंट दे रहा है ना
जी।
जब आप क्रॉस एग्जामिन करेंगे तो आप उनको बताएंगे देखिए ये बैंक स्टेटमेंट है और इससे पैसा आपको अकाउंट में आया, वो कहेगा आया, तो आपने माल सप्लाई नहीं किया तो पैसा किस बात का लिया भाई, आप झूठ नहीं बोल रहे क्या? वो इस बात को डिनाई कैसे करेगा आप बताएं
जी।
और फिर दूसरा क्वेश्चन पूछेंगे कि आपने जीएसटी का ये माल मेरे को दिया नहीं तो आपने जीएसटी की रिटर्न में क्यों दिखाया? आप डर के बोल रहे हैं क्योंकि आपके डिपार्टमेंटल ऑफिसर ने आपको डराया धमकाया इसलिए आपने झूठ बोला। उस टाइम वो कहेगा यस बोला, ना कहेगा तो भी जज तो अपनी बुद्धि लगाएगा ना। आप ये ध्यान रखना, जब आप ऑफिसर से डील करते हो और जब आप जज से डील करते हो उसमें रात दिन का फर्क होता है। जब आप ऑफिसर से डील कर रहे होते हैं उसी ने इन्वेस्टिगेशन करनी है, उसी ने अरेस्ट का ऑर्डर देना है, उसी ने सोकोस देना है, उसी ने डिसाइड करना है, तो वो तो सुनता ही नहीं है। वो तो एक ऐसा है जैसे सीबीआई के बारे में सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने कहा था केस पैरेट है, मनमोहन सिंह सरकार के टाइम की बात बता रहा हूं कि केस पैरेट है। तो इसी तरह ये जो ऑफिसर्स होते हैं इनको पावर ही क्यों दी? आई स्टिल कैन रिमेम्बर जून 2016 के अंदर जब जीएसटी का फर्स्ट ड्राफ्ट आया था उसके अंदर लिखा हुआ था कि सो कॉल्ड नोटिस जो होगा उसका डिसीजन सेम ऑफिसर नहीं करेगा जो इश्यू कर रहा है, लेकिन वही कर रहा है अल्टीमेटली। तो ये क्वेश्चन ऐसे है कि आपकी प्रैक्टिस जितनी निखरेगी, जब आप जितना लो पे रिसर्च करेंगे तो आप मतलब कॉन्फिडेंट हो जाएंगे। आप किसी की दूसरे की जबान को थोड़ी पकड़ सकते हैं। दूसरा, अगर कोई बंदा कह रहा है कि माल सप्लाई नहीं किया, मैं आपसे काउंटर क्वेश्चन पूछता हूं। सपोज आपके ऑफिस के अंदर मेज, चेयर, कुर्सी, लैपटॉप, इतने कंप्यूटर, इतनी किताबें, इतना सामान रखा हुआ है और आपने जगह जगह से खरीदा है और आपका वेंडर ये कह देता है मैंने तो दिया ही नहीं, तो फिर क्या हो जाएगा? फिर आप जेल चले जाएंगे क्या? जब आपने लिया है, आपके ऑफिस में रखा हुआ है, आपके पास बिल है, तो आप क्या किस बात का डरेंगे? ऐसे तो फिर आप बोल देंगे कि नरेंद्र मोदी चोर है तो फिर वो जेल ही चला जाएगा। नहीं
जी,
ऐसे नहीं लो ऐसा नहीं है, इसलिए वो ऑफिसर आपको समझा देता है, क्योंकि मैंने देखा जो मेरी समझ है कि हम ऑफिसर्स के जाल और झंझट में फंस जाते हैं। ही ट्राई टू क्रिएट ए वेब अराउंड योर बॉडी और आपके दिमाग में क्वेश्चन पुट कर देता है, जो मैं बोलता हूं जो मैं समझाता हूं वही लॉ है, उससे बियॉन्ड लॉ ही नहीं है। और मैं जो समझता हूं, मेरी अंडरस्टैंडिंग अलग है, मैं समझता हूं ये करप्ट है, क्योंकि मैं नहीं कह रहा, प्रेजेंट गवर्नमेंट खुद कह रही है देयर इज ए टैक्स टेररिज्म। दूसरा मैं समझता हूं ये 85-90% केस हारते हैं तो इनका केस वैसे ही बेकार है। तीसरा मैं समझता हूं भगवान ने 2-4% बुद्धि मेरे को भी दी है तो केस 100% हम जीत जाएंगे। उनके कहने के बहलावे में नहीं आना चाहिए। तो आप मिस्टर शर्मा यू कैन हैव ए मोर ब्यूटीफुल प्रैक्टिस, वो तो ऐसे ही बोलते रहते हैं, उनकी बातों पर इतना ध्यान नहीं देना चाहिए। आप डिफेंस है, आप अगर पुलिस वालों की बात सुनेंगे आप अपने क्लाइंट को बचा ही नहीं पाएंगे। पुलिस वालों से एक ही क्वेश्चन पूछो, कितने केस में आप भाई सक्सीड है कन्विक्ट कराने में, बोला 8% सक्सेस रेट हमारी, 92% केस में हम कन्विक्ट ही नहीं कर पाते।
जी सर, रेलिवेंसी और एडमिशिबिलिटी जो 136 का आप कह रहे हैं बिल्कुल ठीक, मैं समझ गया ऑफ दिस स्टेटमेंट, वो हम क्रॉस एग्जामिनेशन का राइट तो हमारे पास फ्यूचर में भी है जी।
हाँ ठीक, वो 136 जो पहले 90 होता था ना,
सेक्शन 90 होता था, हाँ जी हाँ जी,
उसके ऊपर आप जजमेंट पढ़िए तो आपको बहुत सारी नॉलेज मिलेगी।
ठीक 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 ठीक, थैंक यू।
आप ध्यान रखना वो ऑफिसर्स नहीं समझता है, ऑफिसर तो पैसे को समझता है। मैं बहुत ब्लंट बोल रहा हूँ, मैंने तो ऑफिसर की ऑनेस्टी देखी नहीं है इस कंट्री में, वो बियरली 5-10% ऑफिसर होंगे जो ऑनेस्ट होंगे, बाकी तो सब डिसऑनेस्ट है। अदरवाइज गवर्नमेंट को ये बोलने की जरूरत क्या है, टैक्स टेररिज्म है। अगर हजारों में से एक ऑफिसर अगर ब्राइब ले लेता या किसी को दुखी कर देता तो टैक्स टेररिज्म वर्ड थोड़ी आता। आज इंडिया के अंदर क्यों कह रहे तो देयर इज ए टेररिस्ट, कि रोज बम ब्लास्ट होते थे इसलिए टेररिस्ट की बात हो रही है। अगर कभी 10 साल में एक बम ब्लास्ट हो जाता और एक आदमी मर जाता तो कोई टेररिस्ट की बात थोड़ी करता।
थैंक यू सर।
सर अनदर क्वेश्चन इज देयर, कैन ऑफिसर रिजेक्ट द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ कैंसिलेशन ऑन द ग्राउंड दैट your GSTR 2A and ITC claimed in GSTR 3P since 2017 is not matching?
No, to my mind he cannot cancel it. If any rule, any circular has been made to this effect, you can challenge those. What I have seen, you know, sometime they issue the circular rules etc. which is contrary to the law. क्योंकि match कभी कर नहीं सकते हैं, आप ध्यान रखिए। मेरा जितना TDS आज मेरे क्लाइंट काटते हैं वो मैच नहीं होता है। लेटेस्ट एग्जांपल देता हूं, मेरे बैंक ने जितना TDS काटा जब रिटर्न भरी लास्ट ईयर, वो मैच नहीं हो रहा। जो मेरे को सर्टिफिकेट दिया है और जो 26AS में आ रहा है वो मैच नहीं हो रहा है। हमने कंप्लेन की हुई है बैंक को, मैच नहीं हो रहा है। तो अब उन्होंने दूसरा TDS का दे दिया है, दूसरे अमाउंट का, वो मैच वो भी नहीं हो रहा है। अब हमारे ऑडिटर ने कहा क्या भाई, जितना 26AS में उतना ही मान लेते हैं, बैंक वालों से कितना मत्थापच्ची करेंगे आप। तो अब ये आपके हाथ में नहीं है ना, बहुत सारी चीजें मैच नहीं करेगी ना। अगर मैच ही करवाना होता तो उन्होंने आज तक वो यूटिलिटी स्टार्ट क्यों नहीं की जिसके बेसिस पे GST बना था कि मैच होना चाहिए। मैच होता नहीं है, मैं आपको बताता हूँ, ये 2017 की बात है। जैसे आप इनकम टैक्स में देखते हैं प्रोप्राइटर से फर्म और प्रोप्राइटर एक ही चीज होती है, लेकिन GST में ऐसा नहीं होता। GST में JK मित्तल एंड JK मित्तल एंड कंपनी दो अलग हो जाते हैं। इनकम टैक्स में पैन नंबर एक ही होता है, प्रोप्राइटर का और प्रोप्राइटरशिप फर्म का। अब आपने प्रोप्राइटरशिप फर्म का GST रजिस्ट्रेशन ले लिया और लिखते हुए आपने उसमें JK मित्तल लिख दिया तो मैच करेगा ही नहीं। उसका पूरा नहीं लिखा नाम, थोड़ा सा एक वर्ड भी मिस्टेक हो गई तो मैच नहीं करता। तो ये एक लॉन्ग ड्रंग प्रोसेस होता है जो आज तक आपने मैच किया नहीं। कई बार ये, अब ये सब मत मानो कि कोई बहुत ही एक्सपर्ट उसमें बैठेगा उसमें पंचिंग करने के लिए, कोई क्लर्क बैठेगा, कोई इंटरमीडिएटरी बैठेगा, कोई अकाउंटेंट बैठेगा, मिस्टेक्स भी 50 होती है, उसके लिए रजिस्ट्रेशन कैंसिल कर दोगे। दूसरा मैं बताता हूं, ये जो डिपार्टमेंट की अप्रोच है ना रजिस्ट्रेशन कैंसिल करने की, मैं होता ना मैं ये प्रोविजन ही नहीं बनाता लोन। आप रजिस्ट्रेशन कैंसिल करके क्या ऑब्जेक्टिव अचीव करेंगे? आपको जो टैक्स कलेक्ट हो रहा है उसका बंद ही करवा देंगे। अब उसका मिसमैच हो रहा है तो भाई मैच हो जाएगा ना। आपने इनकम टैक्स में कभी सुना है किसी का पैन नंबर कैंसिल हुआ? आज तक मैंने नहीं सुना। जो मर गए हैं ना उनका पैन नंबर भी आज तक चल रहा है, क्योंकि इनकम टैक्स वाले कह रहे हैं हमारा जो टारगेट है उससे 2-4% फालतू आएगा, 50% फालतू आता है। कैंसिल करके हमें क्या मिलेगा? हमारा टारगेट ही पूरा नहीं होगा। सबसे ज्यादा ब्लैक मनी है फिर भी किसी का इनकम टैक्स का पैन नंबर कैंसिल हुआ क्या? बताओ, जिसके बाहर फॉरन के अकाउंट की डिटेल आ गई उसका भी पैन नंबर आज तक कैंसिल नहीं हुआ। तो ये जो ऑब्जेक्टिव है, जो मेरी अंडरस्टैंडिंग है, ये ऑब्जेक्टिव ही गलत है। अगर इनकम टैक्स में भी अगर ये कर दें तो खुश हो जाएंगे लोग। अब मैं आपको एक एग्जांपल देता हूं मेरी लाइफ में जो हुआ, आप कैसे केस को फाइट कर सकते हैं कैसे। देखिए, थॉट प्रोसेस पे है। अगर आप थॉट प्रोसेस कांग्रेस से अफेक्टेड है तो कांग्रेस जैसी थिंकिंग आएगी, और अगर आप मोदी से अफेक्टेड है तो मोदी जैसी थिंकिंग आएगी, आप भगवान राम से अफेक्टेड है तो राम जैसी आएगी, बजरंग बली से तो बजरंग बली। मैं नहीं डरता किसी से, क्यों नहीं डरता? भगवान जी की पूजा करने लगे थे सीए स्टार्ट करने से पहले, भगवान जी कहता मैं हूं ना, क्यों डरते हो? तो मेरे पास एक लेटर आया कि मेरी वाइफ का और मेरा इलेक्शन कमीशन का कार्ड कैंसिल कर दिया। कैंसिलेशन पे ही बता रहा हूं आप, और ये बात ज्यादा पुरानी नहीं है, ये बात 3 साल पुरानी होगी। तो आ गया तो ठीक है, मैंने कहा मैं खुश हो गया। मैंने कहा कम से कम, क्योंकि मैंने आज तक कभी ऐसा नहीं हुआ वोट कास्ट ना किया, मैं हमेशा वोट कास्ट किया है 18 साल का जब से हुआ। तो मैंने उसकी इन्वेस्टिगेशन स्टार्ट की, उसका लेटर पढ़ा तो उसमें लिखा हुआ था हम आपके घर आए और आप मिले नहीं इसलिए आपका कैंसिल कर दिया। 2 मिनट लूंगा लेकिन ये वर्थ है लिसनिंग। फिर मैंने क्या किया, जो स्पीड पोस्ट से लेटर आया था उसकी ट्रैकिंग रिपोर्ट निकाली, क्योंकि उस लेटर में ये भी लिखा हुआ था आप इतने तारीख को हमारे पास आ जाए, और ये जीएसटी में भी मैं रोज देखता। एंड देन आई वंस इन्वेस्टिगेटेड इट, व्हाट आई फाउंड दैट कि लेटर उन्होंने 6 या 7 दिन के बाद पोस्ट किया जो उन्होंने डेट लिखी। उस लेटर के अंदर यह भी नहीं लिखा हुआ कब मेरे घर आया, कौन ऑफिसर मेरे घर आया, किस तारीख या किस टाइम पे आया। तो मैंने इलेक्शन कमीशन को एक मेल डाल दी सिर्फ, क्योंकि मैंने नरेंद्र मोदी को वोट दिया है इसलिए आपने मेरा इलेक्शन कमीशन का कार्ड कैंसिल कर दिया, और मैं ब्राइब देता नहीं, और मेरा आपने समय बचा दिया, यही लेटर मैं प्रधानमंत्री को लिख रहा हूं। जैसे ही मैंने ये बात लिखी और बोली, इलेक्शन कमीशन के ऑफिसर्स मेरे ऑफिस में चक्कर लगाने लगे, बाबा हमारी जिंदगी बचाओ। मैंने कहा तुम्हें अभी पता नहीं है तुम किस इंसान से बात कर रहे हो, मैं तुम्हारी जान ले लूंगा, तुम्हें बताना पड़ेगा अगर तुम मेरे घर पे आए हो तो किस दिन आए हो। उन्होंने मेरे को पहले सर्टिफिकेट दिया आपका कार्ड कैंसिल नहीं हुआ, फिर नया बना के मेरे को कार्ड दिया, बोला आपको आने की जरूरत नहीं हम आपके ऑफिस में बना के दिए। तो जब आपका कैंसिलेशन अगर रजिस्ट्रेशन होता है आप कैसे जज के सामने केस पुट करोगे, क्योंकि डिस्प्यूट्स तो इनकम टैक्स में भी रोज चल रहे हैं। आपने कितने केस आज तक कितने क्लाइंटों के कर रहे हो, सबके पैन नंबर तो कैंसिल ही हो जाने चाहिए, फिर वो बिजनेस कैसे करेगा। आपने कहा है कि उसका मैच नहीं कर रहा है, तो मैच तो इनकम टैक्स में भी नहीं करता है, इज इट नॉट करेक्ट? मैच करने की आप कोशिश करोगे ना, वो डिपार्टमेंटल ऑफिसर पहले बताए मैच नहीं कर रहा तो किस किस का मैच नहीं कर रहा है क्या कर रहा है, वो तो बताएगा नहीं, बस वो तो एक लाइन लिख देगा मैच नहीं कर रहा है। तो ये अप्रोच ही गलत है मेरे हिसाब से। देर आर वैलिड रीजन फॉर यू टू चैलेंज इट एंड टू सक्सीड इट। आपका माइक बंद है नरेश जी, माइक बंद है आपका।
यस सर। सतीश भी आपकी क्वेरी यू कैन रेज। सतीश बाबू आपका म्यूट है।
सर, इफ यू रिसीव एनी कम्युनिकेशन विदाउट डीन, आर वी बाउंड टू रिप्लाई इट और शुड वी आस्क फॉर द डीन?
नो, व्हाई यू शुड आस्क फॉर द डीन?
वी शुड नॉट आस्क।
यू शुड नॉट आस्क। यू रीड दैट सर्कुलर। सर्कुलर क्लियरली सेइंग इफ इट इज विदाउट अ डीन नंबर देन इट विल बी डीम्ड टू बी इनवैलिड एंड नेवर बीन इशू। देयर आर टू एक्सेप्शन टू दैट। You read those exceptions also. If the officer was not in the office, like search होती है और होती है, लेकिन I am sure you are not asking about those communication. You are asking about the simple communication that I can understand. So why you should answer it when the law itself says it is doomed to be invalid? And you go to the YouTube, you read Nirmala Sitharaman hear her for 2 minutes का एक video है. When she was addressing to the certain traders. कि ये इनवैलिड है, फाड़ के फेंक दे डस्टबिन में। तो फिर हम क्यों मांगे? मांगने का मतलब है आ बैल मुझे मार।
ओके सर, थैंक यू।
राइट, सचिन जी।
यस सर।
सर सचिन जी, क्वेरी।
यस प्लीज। सचिन जी आप म्यूट है, आप ऑन करिए माइक को।
सर आवाज आ रहा है?
Yes.
आ रहा है सचिन। यस,
Sir, thank you so much for enlightening us and making a point that at very times the CAs are not capable. मतलब उनका कई बार qualification में से फर्क पड़ जाता है कि evidence किसको लेना किसको नहीं लेना. सर एक चीज ये पूछनी थी मुझे कि first hand क्या करना चाहिए अगर officer बोलते हैं मैं arrest कर रहा हूँ या arrest warrant issue कर रहा हूँ तो first hand action क्या लेना चाहिए.
देखिए अंडर द लॉ अगर कोई अरेस्ट कर रहा है तो आप कोई एक्शन नहीं ले सकते. आपको प्रोसीजर जानना है. द लॉ सेज इफ ही इज गोइंग टू अरेस्ट ही हैज टू मेक ए कम्युनिकेशन टू ऑफ हिज इमीडिएट रिलेटिव. वो अरेस्टी पर्सन का एक रिलेटिव का एड्रेस लेके कम्युनिकेट करेगा इमीडिएटली. दूसरा अरेस्ट वारंट के अंदर रीजन लिख के देगा कि वो किस रीजन से अरेस्ट कर रहा है. ये नहीं कह सकता बस मैं अरेस्ट कर रहा हूँ जीएसटी में. नो, जीएसटी में ए बी सी डी चार क्लास में उसको पावर है तो कौन से क्लोज में कर रहा है उसको उसकी ब्रीफ डिस्क्रिप्शन देनी पड़ेगी. सेक्शन को कोट नहीं करना है सिर्फ उसको अपने फैक्चुअल फैक्ट्स लिखने पड़ेंगे तब वो अरेस्ट कर सकता है. आप अरेस्ट अगर वो कर रहा है तो उसके अड़चन डालेंगे तो आपके ऊपर एक केस और बन जाएगा. अगर वो इनलीगली कर रहा है यू हैव टू गो टू द कोर्ट. आप उससे फाइट नहीं कर सकते लॉ में कि कोई उससे अब्यूज करेंगे ये करेंगे बट आप उससे डॉक्यूमेंट मांगेंगे. दूसरा उसका मेडिकल टेस्ट वो कराएगा. तीसरा वो विद इन 24 आवर्स उसको एक मजिस्ट्रेट के पास ले जाना जरूरी होता है. जैसे ही मजिस्ट्रेट के पास ले जाएंगे वहीं से आपकी पावर स्टार्ट होती है. आप उसी टाइम भी वकील को ला सकते हैं जो वो अरेस्ट कर रहा है. मजिस्ट्रेट के सामने आप तुरंत बेल एप्लीकेशन लगाएंगे और अपने पॉइंट को रखेंगे और वो मजिस्ट्रेट के सामने रात के 12 बजे भी ले जा सकता है 1 बजे भी ले जा सकता है. मजिस्ट्रेट ऑन ड्यूटी रहता है. कोई ना कोई मजिस्ट्रेट हमेशा ऑन ड्यूटी रहता है 24 आवर्स. उसकी परमिशन के बाद ही उसको जेल में किया जाएगा या उसको छोड़ भी सकता है मजिस्ट्रेट. तो अगर आप ये पॉइंट एकदम से रख देंगे कि माय लॉर्ड व्हाट इज देयर एलिगेशन प्लीज टेल अस, उनसे पूछिए आप तो कहेंगे सप्लाई नहीं किया. तो माय लॉर्ड पहले तो यही देखिए अगर सप्लाई नहीं है तो जीएसटी लॉ में भी आते हैं क्या. दूसरा एविडेंस तो देखिए एट द फेस ऑफ इट एविडेंस है क्या नहीं है. सिर्फ कहने से नहीं कर सकते ना आप. दिस इज नॉट ए क्रिमिनल लॉ. हेयर इज एविडेंस बेस्ड लॉ. सिर्फ स्टेटमेंट पे अरेस्ट नहीं होता है यहां. एविडेंस बेस्ड होता है एप्लीकेशन ऑफ माइंड. आप कमिश्नर की फाइल तो मंगा के देखें तो सही एक बात. अदरवाइज वो कर देगा तो देन आप फिर बेल एप्लीकेशन फॉर्मल लगा सकते हैं. डेट ये प्रोसीजर चलेगा. लेकिन क्योंकि ये होता है कोर्ट हमेशा दोनों तरफ देखती है. कोर्ट एकदम ये भी नहीं कह सकती चले जाओ क्योंकि वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू प्रीजज द इश्यू. लेकिन आप कोर्ट को लीगली प्रोसीजर में सेटिस्फाई कर देंगे तो कोर्ट विल ग्रांट यू द बेल. और आप इनको को इनलीगल अरेस्ट कर रहा है 5 करोड़ से कम में कर ही नहीं सकता. इससे टोटल अमाउंट तो पूछिए नहीं तो देन दैट वुड बी द बेस्ट रेमेडी. बाकी ऐसे रेमेडी नहीं है. फिर उसमें क्या होता है ऑफिसर अलर्ट हो जाता है. जहां बिल्कुल झूठा केस होता है ना वो अपने आप ही सोचता है कि यहाँ पे कोई अपोज मत करो या अरेस्ट मत करो क्योंकि अदरवाइज उसका सारा ही केस खत्म हो जाता
है. सर हमारे केस में ऐसा हुआ था कि जो डायरेक्टर थे उनको कॉल किया कि हम आपको सिर्फ स्टेटमेंट के लिए बुला रहे और वहीं पर उनको अरेस्ट कर दिया.
देखिए जहां तक स्टेटमेंट पहली बात तो कॉल करने पर आपको जाना ही नहीं चाहिए. स्टेटमेंट जो बुलाते हैं बिना सम्मन के स्टेटमेंट रिकॉर्ड ही नहीं कर सकते. सम्मन आना चाहिए था. आप कटसी में जा रहे हैं. दूसरा जब वो अरेस्ट कर रहे हैं तो उन्होंने गेम प्लान बनाया. अदरवाइज आपको कोर्ट के जीएसटी के जजमेंट ही मिल जाएंगे. सम्मन आपको पावर अरेस्ट करने की नहीं देता है. पावर अरेस्ट करने की कमिश्नर के पास है लेकिन वो प्ले करते हैं कमिश्नर से बाद में या एक्स पोस्ट फैक्टो साइन करा लेते हैं या पहले से साइन करा के रख लेते हैं. बोला आएगा जब फंसा लेंगे. दैट इज देयर मोडस ऑपरेंडी. ये मोडस ऑपरेंडी उनको चोरों के साथ खेलनी चाहिए. आप समझ गए ना जैसे टेररिस्ट के साथ होनी चाहिए. क्योंकि कई बार जब आप ऐसे लोगों से डील करते हैं टेररिस्ट से लॉ मे नॉट बी अप्लाइड इन ए लिटरल सेंस पर जब आप बिजनेसमैन से डील करते हो जहां रिकॉर्डेड ट्रांजेक्शन होती है उसमें लॉ की अप्लीकेशन लिटल डिफरेंट होती है क्योंकि वो भाग नहीं सकता ना. टेररिस्ट होता है उसके तो हाथ पैर ही नहीं होते वो तो छुपके रहता है. जो बिजनेसमैन होता है वो तो ऑन रिकॉर्ड ट्रांजेक्शन कर रहा है वो कहां भागेगा भाई. नहीं तो आप तुरंत कोर्ट में जाएंगे आप अरेस्ट चैलेंज करेंगे आप बेल लगाएंगे ये सारे प्रोसीजर लगेंगे आप अपने रिकॉर्ड को एग्जामिन करेंगे ये सब चीजों पे. और आपका केस जिस दिन से स्टार्ट होता है उसी दिन से क्लियर हो जाएंगे ना. जैसे बताया ना कि आपको कोरोना काल में अगर छोटा सा भी एक स्नीज भी आ जाते ना घर में आप पूछना वाइफ से वो कितनी वरीड हो जाती. पहले वरीड नहीं होते थे. बोला नहाने से आ गई होगी एसी में आ गई होगी. अब तो एकदम वरीनेस आने लगती है.
तो इसी तरह मेरी माँ ने तो सिखाया था छोटी सी फुंसी होने पे इलाज कराना चाहिए, फोड़ा होने का इंतजार नहीं। हम मिस्टेक क्या करते हैं, हमारे क्लाइंट क्या करते हैं, कुछ नहीं होगा कुछ नहीं होगा कुछ नहीं होगा, और वो केस को इतना बिगाड़ लेते हैं। ऑफिसर से मिल मिल के उनको इंफॉर्मेशन देते रहते हैं, ऑफिसर को सारी जानकारी देते रहते हैं, और फिर कभी आपका ऑफिसर थोड़ी भला कर सकता, आपका दुश्मन कभी भला नहीं कर सकता। व्हाई यू आर पार्टिंग विद योर स्ट्रेटेजी विद दैम, यू हैव टू पार्ट विद ओनली दोज डॉक्यूमेंट दोज इंफॉर्मेशन Which is required to be submitted in the law. आप जब भी ट्रस्टवर्दी नहीं होते हैं ऑफिसर्स, इंडिया के तो नहीं है, मैं रोज ही देखता हूं वो चीट करते हैं, तो यही मैं उनको समझाना चाहता हूं। इसलिए इनकम टैक्स डिपार्टमेंट का एनवायरमेंट मेरे को थोड़ा अलग लगता है, जो मेरे काउंटर पार्ट मेरे को बताते हैं, आई डू नॉट नो, आई हैव नो पर्सनल एक्सपीरियंस। वहां पर इतनी चीटिंग वगैरह नहीं है, ट्रस्टवर्दी है। आपको अगर इनफॉर्मली भी एक बार बोल दो कि बैंक स्टेटमेंट ला दो, आप दे आएंगे, क्योंकि आप उसको पता हो मिस यूज नहीं करेगा। यहाँ पे उसी चीज को मिसयूज करने लगता है, यहाँ पे इनको सर्च कंडक्ट करने का नहीं पता। मेरा केस पड़ी है सावरिया फूड्स का, मेरे क्लाइंट के जीएसटी ऑफिसर सारे इमोवेबल प्रॉपर्टी के ओरिजिनल सेल डीड उठा के ले गए और पंचनामे पे लिख दिया, फोटोकॉपी नीचे साइन करा ली। और मेरा क्लाइंट 6 महीने तक मीटिंग करता रहा, बोला मिल जाएंगे। मैंने कहा मैं नरेंद्र मोदी तो नहीं मिल जाएंगे, मैं तो कोर्ट ले जा सकता हूँ, कोर्ट के थ्रू ही मिलेंगे। और कोर्ट लेके गए, सारे मिल गए, और ऑफिसर ने लिख के दिया कि ये मैं ओरिजिनल लेके गया, मैंने गलती से लिखा है, और उसकी विजिलेंस इंक्वायरी स्टार्ट करा दी कोर्ट ने। तो देयरफॉर रेमेडी होती है लॉ में, लेकिन एक बार जब इमीडिएट कोई अरेस्ट होता है, इमीडिएटली तो आप उसको रोक नहीं पाएंगे ना। फिर इमीडिएटली कई बार लगता है नहीं इतने पैसे हैं, उसको घूस दे दो, ये दे दो, घूस देने से वो अरेस्ट नहीं रुकने वाली, महीना पोस्टपोन करा लोगे। आप जितने क्लाइंटों को डील कर रहे हो या जितने लोगों को देखे, एक मेरा क्लाइंट, मेरे को रायपुर का क्लाइंट, मैं उस दिन बेंगलोर हाईकोर्ट में था, वहां पे मिलने आया मेरी एडवाइस लेने, ₹1,00,000 तो फ्लाइट पे खर्च करके आया मेरी एडवाइस लेने, और मैंने कहा कोर्ट में आज केस डाल दो। और फिर 1 साल के बाद अब पेंडेमिक में उसने मेरे से एडवाइस ली, उसके ब्रदर ने बोला वो तो अरेस्ट हो गए, तो मैंने कहा फिर क्यों इतने दिन तक नहीं किया, बोला हमने सोचा वो गुस्सा ना हो जाए इसलिए हमने केस नहीं डाला। तो मैंने कहा बड़ा प्यार किया ना, 1 साल तक ₹1,00,000 तो ब्राइब ले ली होगी, चाहे आप बताओ ना बताओ, और ब्राइब देने का फायदा ये मिला कि अभी भी आप जेल में ही हो। नहीं तो इन पे ट्रस्ट करना वो नहीं है, बल्कि ब्राइब दे दे के आप पैसे तो खोते ही हो, आप एविडेंस भी खो देते हो अपने सपोर्ट के, एविडेंस क्रिएट करवाता है आपसे। तो ये तो प्रैक्टिकल केस डील करोगे जब ही आपको पता चलेगा। यस प्लीज,
नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन महेश जी, महेंद्र जी का भी क्वेश्चन था, विशाल जी आप कर लीजिए आपका क्वेश्चन, जब तक थोड़ा स्पीड अप कर लेते, एक्चुअली वी आर रनिंग शॉर्ट ऑफ टाइम। विशाल जी आपका क्वेश्चन।
थैंक यू सर फॉर द ऑपर्चुनिटी। सर एक्चुअली वन ऑफ माय क्लाइंट को सेक्शन 74 में समन मिला था और उनका इन्वेस्टिगेशन हुआ एंड उनका ग्रोस लाइबिलिटी नियर 3 लाख बना और उन्होंने सारा लाइबिलिटी ITC यूटिलाइज करके पे कर दिया। एक्चुअली क्लाइंट था ट्राइबल आदमी तो उनको एक्चुअली बिल्कुल अवेयरनेस नहीं था, उनको इनकम टैक्स भी अप्लाई नहीं होता, 1026 में एग्जम्पशन है जैसे कि अरुणाचल में। तो उनका एक्चुअली अकाउंटेंट ने, उनके किसी अकाउंटेंट ने उनकी नील रिटर्न्स फाइल कर दी थी और जब उन्होंने फाइल हमको ट्रांसफर की तो हमको डॉक्यूमेंट सारे प्रोवाइड नहीं किए, बट हमने इनपुट अंडर द टाइम लिमिट सारा क्लेम करके रख दिया, बट ड्यू टू नॉन अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ द सेल्स रिकॉर्ड्स हमने वो लाइबिलिटी पे नहीं की। बट बीच में उसी पीरियड में उनके अकाउंटेंट ने उनसे 1 करोड़ रुपए GST पे करवा दिया था, जबकि उनका टर्नओवर ओनली 10-15 crores पर एनम था। तो ऐसे केस में एक्चुअली उनका जो नेट लाइबिलिटी था जब DGGI का नोटिस मिला तो वो ऑलरेडी पेड था, बट ITC एक्यूमुलेट हो गया और उन्होंने उसको यूटिलाइज करके पे नहीं किया था। तो ऐसे केस में उन्होंने वो बैलेंस DRC 03 से पे कर दिया, बट अभी वो पेनल्टी भी उस पर डिमांड कर रहे हैं, इंटरेस्ट नील था बिकॉज ग्रोस लाइबिलिटी ITC यूटिलाइज करके पे किया और रेट्रोस्पेक्टिव इफेक्ट से अमेंड हो गया, बट अभी वो डिमांड कर रहे 25% उस पे पेनल्टी। तो सर
देखिए, आई थिंक द 2-3 things मे नॉट बी द करेक्ट फैक्ट्स। फर्स्ट थिंग, द समन कैन नेवर बी इशूड अंडर सेक्शन 74, सो कॉज नोटिस आया होगा आपको। अगर सम्मन आया तो 74 में वो गलत है, या तो सेक्शन गलत लिखा। दूसरा, अगर आप ये बताएं कि सो कॉज नोटिस अभी आया है क्या आपको, नहीं, आपका माइक बंद हो गया है, माइक बंद हो गया है मिस्टर विशाल, नहीं, यू आर ऑन म्यूट,
स्टिल ऑन,
यस
यस। मैन जी आपका क्वेश्चन नेक्स्ट है।
नहीं नहीं, वो विशाल जी म्यूट पे हैं, वो क्वेश्चन म्यूट पे हैं, मिस्टर विशाल आप म्यूट पे, यस अब बताइए।
ओके, एक्चुअली मेरे को अनम्यूट कर दिया था, म्यूट कर दिया था एक्चुअली। तो एडजुडिकेशन अथॉरिटी को उन्होंने पावर ट्रांसफर कर दिया समन के लिए, तो अभी एडजुडिकेशन अथॉरिटी के पास जाने से वो डिमांड कर रहे हैं 25% पेनल्टी विद इन 30 डेज पे करने के लिए, अभी 3 करोड़ का ग्रोस लायबिलिटी पे किया।
मैं आपको बिल्कुल सिंपल बताता हूँ, वो डिमांड ऐसे नहीं कर सकते, इनफॉर्मल कुछ भी नहीं होता लॉ में, एक 74 का सम्मन नहीं देते हैं, 74 का शोकॉज नोटिस आपको देंगे। अगर बिना
एससीएन मिला था सर,
एससीएन मिला है तो उसका आपको रिप्लाई फाइल करना पड़ेगा, पूरी तरह कंटेस्ट करना पड़ेगा कि नो पेनल्टीज लेवियबल, क्योंकि आपकी इंटेंशन कोई ऐसी थी नहीं, ना आपने फ्रॉड किया, जो भी उन्होंने एलिगेशन लगाया उसी का रिप्लाई देना है, जो एलिगेशन नहीं लगाया उसका रिप्लाई नहीं देना। 4-5 इंग्रेडिएंट्स है ना उसमें, फ्रॉड मिसस्टेटमेंट सप्रेशन, उन्होंने कौन सा इंग्रेडिएंट का लगाया, फिर 2-3 आप जजमेंट देखेंगे, जैसे एक संजीव फैब्रिक का जजमेंट है, या आप धर्मेंद्र टेक्सटाइल का जजमेंट देखेंगे कि आपने कोई फ्रॉड नहीं किया, आपने कोई जानबूझ के इंटेंशन टू इवेड नहीं थी, आपसी मिस्टेक हुई है तो वहां पे पेनल्टी फिर कंटेस्ट आप करेंगे, तब उसके बाद उसका फैसला होगा, फिर भी आपके अगेंस्ट आएगा तो यू कैन फाइल एन अपील, दैट विल बी द लीगल प्रोसीजर। अब बाकी इससे ज्यादा तो जब तक डॉक्यूमेंट नहीं देख लो किस किस ग्राउंड पे पेनल्टी बच सकती है, कैसे बच सकती है, लेकिन मेरे को लग रहा है जो आपने जेन्युइननेस बताई, क्योंकि आपने ऑलरेडी क्रेडिट था, आपने क्रेडिट था तो जब इंटरेस्ट भी नहीं लगना है तो फिर आपको पेमेंट कितनी बैलेंस, आपने कितनी और पेमेंट कैश में करनी पड़ती है, डीआरसी जीरो
जीरो
जीरो, फिर क्या, फिर पेनल्टी का क्वेश्चन है, मतलब यू कैन सेव द पेनल्टी, देयर इज अ गुड केस, बट ओनली यू हैव टू फाइट इट आउट। यस, नेक्स्ट,
या नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, सीए मोनिका राठी, योर क्वेश्चन इज देयर, मोनिका राठी।
नरेश भाई मैं ले रहा हूँ।
यस सर।
सर नमस्कार।
नमस्कार
सर, एक्चुअल ऐसा है कि मेरी एक पार्टी है जो कि सप्लाई करती कॉटन वगैरह।
ओके।
तो वो दिल्ली में उस पार्टी का रेड हुई थी जिसको हम सप्लाई करते, दिल्ली से इंटेलिजेंस ने हमको समन्स भेजा कि पर्सनली पूरे डाटा के साथ दिल्ली उपस्थित हो, क्या ऐसे समन्स भेज सकते हैं जबकि हमारा एक पर्टिकुलर सप्लाई है उसको, लिमिटेड बिल्स हैं और पर्सनली अटेंड होना कंपलसरी रहता है क्या, और पूरा डाटा मांग सकते क्या वो?
नहीं, अगर इन्वेस्टिगेशन उस कंपनी की चल रही है तो उस कंपनी से रिलेटेड ही डाटा मांग सकते हैं, आपकी इन्वेस्टिगेशन नहीं चल रही तो आपका पूरा डाटा नहीं मांग सकते, पहली बात। दूसरा, समन वो जरूर भेज सकते हैं, ऐसा नहीं है कि समन आपको नहीं भेज सकते, लेकिन यू कैन चैलेंज दैट समन अगर आपको लगता है कि समन टोटली आर्बिट्री है। तीसरा, अगर डाटा मांगा है सिर्फ, तो डाटा आप किसी भी आदमी को भेज के भी भेज सकते हैं, आपको पर्सनली जाने की जरूरत नहीं है, लेकिन चाहे कितना ही पर्सनली लिखे, उनके लिखने से नहीं होता है। नेक्स्ट, अगर समन के अंदर उसने ये लिखा कि नहीं वी वॉन्ट टू रिकॉर्ड यूर स्टेटमेंट, तो स्टेटमेंट तो फिर उसी आदमी की रिकॉर्ड होगी जिसको उन्होंने बुलाया, स्टेटमेंट कोई दूसरा नहीं दे सकता। लेकिन देर आर सो मेनी थिंग्स हैपन, अगर आपको लगता है कि नहीं आप जा नहीं सकते हैं, या आपको ये लगता है कि आप उसकी स्टेटमेंट के लिए कैपेबल ही नहीं है, जो चीज की मेरे को जानकारी नहीं मैं कह दूंगा, तो यू कैन से कि दीज ट्रांजेक्शन और दीज बिजनेस और दीज थिंग्स आर बींग हैंडल बाई सो एंड सो, वी हैव नॉमिनेटेड सो एंड सो, फिर वो उसको समन भेज देगा, आप उसकी स्टेटमेंट रिकॉर्ड कर सकते हैं। नेक्स्ट, समन के अंदर उन्होंने क्या लैंग्वेज की है, उसमें भी नरेंद्र मोदी गवर्नमेंट ने एक समन का फॉर्मेट इशू कर दिया, क्योंकि समन भी वो डरावने वाली लैंग्वेज यूज करने भेजते थे कि हमसे बिना पूछे कोई दफ्तर नहीं छोड़ेगा, ये नहीं करेगा, ऐसे नहीं करेगा, वो ऐसी लैंग्वेज यूज नहीं कर सकते हैं समन में। अगर ऐसी लैंग्वेज यूज कर रहे हो तो आप कोर्ट जा सकते हैं कि जान करके हमें डरा रहे हैं, कॉन्ट्रेरी टू द लॉ, इनका ऑब्जेक्टिव ही गलत है, ये हरेसी करना चाहते हैं, जो लॉ में ही परमिट नहीं हो ऐसी लैंग्वेज क्यों यूज कर रहा है, तो ये रेमेडी आपके पास है। अदरवाइज तो देखो ऐसे केसेस में फ्रेंकली स्पीकिंग क्या होता है, जब तक आप 1-to-1 पूरे डॉक्यूमेंट के साथ किसी से मिलो ना, क्योंकि उसी के ऊपर डिपेंड करता है कि आप कैसे, जैसे मैंने आज बिगनिंग में बताया, मेरे पास अभी 6-7 पार्टियों के आए हैं और मैंने देखा कि वो केस पहले किसी और एडवोकेट ने हैंडल किया, अब हमारे पास आया, उसके अंदर उसके एडवोकेट ने भी लिखा है कि 6 समन आए और 6 के 6 एक ही डी नंबर से आए, तो क्यों ने कंप्लेंट की भाई फाइनेंस मिनिस्ट्री को, लोएस्ट नंबर, तो फिर तो डिन नंबर ही यूज नहीं करना, फिर तो एक ही डिन नंबर जनरेट करो पूरी लाइफ में, वही यूज करते रहो, फिर तो डिन नंबर का ऑब्जेक्टिव ही खत्म हो गया। तो ये सेफगार्ड आप नहीं मिल रहे हैं तो आप उसको ले सकते हैं।
सीए मोनिका राठी, आपकी क्वेरी, एंड कुणाल बुद्राजा जी आप अनम्यूट कर सकते हैं।
कुणाल, Can I?
Yeah, you can raise your question.
Yeah. Thank you, Mittal sir, for your approach on GST assessments. But sir, मेरी query है. I had a client. Client ने 2017-18 में एक पार्टी से क्रेडिट लिया था इनवॉइस का अराउंड 3 lakh rupees. सामने वाली पार्टी ने जीएसटी रिटर्न नहीं फाइल किया. हम लोग का जीएसटी ऑडिट आया डिपार्टमेंट के एंड से और वो 3 lakh का क्रेडिट हम लोग का डिसअलाउ किया, विच वी एक्सेप्टेड, वी पेड द अमाउंट और उस पर इंटरेस्ट भी हम लोग ने भर दिया एंड वी चार्ज दिस अमाउंट टू आवर टू द पार्टी हु हैड बिल्ड अस द अमाउंट. वो पार्टी ने भी हम लोग का अमाउंट डेबिट कर लिया हम लोग के अकाउंट में. अभी उन लोगों को नोटिस आई है सर कि दैट यू नीड टू पे दिस अमाउंट विद इंटरेस्ट एंड पेनल्टी. नाउ दैट क्लाइंट इज आस्किंग द अमाउंट बैक फ्रॉम अस फॉर द सेम अमाउंट. इन दिस केस हाउ टू प्रोसीड बिकॉज दिस इज द सेम जीएसटी.
अमाउंट आपका छोटा है लेकिन लीगल क्वेश्चन बहुत अच्छा है, यही मैं आपको बताने की कोशिश कर रहा था.
ये लीगल सर अमाउंट छोटा था लेकिन लीगली
आप भूल जाएं, यू जस्ट फॉरगेट अमाउंट एंड देन लिसन.
यस सर.
लोग कैन नॉट allow someone to take a double benefit.
Yes.
They want to collect tax from you and your vendor. How it could be collected? That's why I always said कि आपने तो ईमानदारी दिखा के पे कर दिया. पे करने का क्या फायदा हुआ? आपके झगड़े बढ़ते चले गए. They have made a law like that कि पहले डिपार्टमेंट से झगड़ो, फिर अपने वेंडर से झगड़ो, सबसे रिश्ते खराब कर लो. तो ऐसे में कुछ पे जाना चाहिए कि आप दोनों पार्टियों से नहीं ले सकते. पहले तो आपको एक सिंपल रिप्लाई देनी चाहिए डिपार्टमेंट में, ऑलरेडी आप टैक्स कलेक्ट कर चुके हो, यू कांट कलेक्ट. दोनों साइड से आप ये टैक्स कलेक्ट नहीं कर सकते. अगर उसी पर मान जाए ठीक है, नहीं माने तो आप कोर्ट जाएं, कोर्ट नहीं जाएं तो केस बनाएंगे, तो आप केस में सारे एविडेंस लगाएंगे, यू विल गेट सक्सेस. आप वो जो जजमेंट मैंने आज मद्रास हाईकोर्ट का है वो भी आप देखिए, उसमें लिखा हुआ आप सेलर से कलेक्ट करें. अब पहले तो बायर से इंसिस्ट करते हैं, फिर वो सेलर से इंसिस्ट करते हैं, दोनों से नहीं ले सकते.
अच्छा, अभी वो सेलर भरेगा भी तो टाइम बैरिंग का पॉइंट आ जाएगा क्योंकि 17-18 का है तो मुझे
तो क्रेडिट भी नहीं मिलेगा.
हाँ, तो मुझे क्रेडिट भी नहीं मिलेगा. अगर वो भर भी देता है तो क्रेडिट मुझे एलिजिबल नहीं होगा.
सेलर को आप अपने डॉक्यूमेंट्स दे दो कि हम ऑलरेडी पे कर चुके हैं, ये डिपार्टमेंट के नोटिस आए थे और उसके बाद आपने भी हमें दे दिया, ये डिपार्टमेंट को इन्फॉर्म कर दे बस.
लेकिन सर अभी यहाँ पे भी और एक इशू है. चलो यहाँ पे तो मैंने मेरा पहला हो चुका, लेकिन अगर ये टेक्निकली हम लोग देखने जा रहे हैं, अगर किसी ने सितंबर के बाद फाइल किया और उसने पेमेंट भी कर दिया, बाद में अगर मुझे डिपार्टमेंट मेरे पास आता है कि सर दिस इज नॉट एलिजिबल क्रेडिट, आप ये रिवर्स करो.
नहीं नहीं नहीं, फिर आप अरे भाई आपने उसको उसने फाइल नहीं किया तो उससे आपका क्रेडिट इन एलिजिबल नहीं हो जाएगा और उसने तो लेट फाइल भी कर दिया है. तभी तो मद्रास हाई कोर्ट सेड अगर ये ऐसा सिचुएशन होती उसने पे कर दिया आपके पास बाद में आता है तो यू आर नॉट लायबल टू पे टैक्स एट ऑल. आप तो फर्स्ट प्लेस पे भी लायबल नहीं हो. तभी तो मैंने 3 जजमेंट आपको दिखाए आज.
हाँ सर, वो जजमेंट्स मैंने अच्छे से देखे, लेकिन आपके जजमेंट्स और डिपार्टमेंट का जो रवैया है वो बहुत अलग हो जाता है सर. डिपार्टमेंट में तो वो लोग अपने
कह रहा हूँ, आप थोड़ा समझिए, वो बिल्कुल ठीक कह रहे हैं. मैं ये नहीं कह रहा कि यू आर रॉन्ग. व्हाट आई एम सेइंग इज द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफिसर्स बिहेव बैडली तो आपको थोड़ी सी लड़ाई लंबी लड़नी पड़ेगी, आप अल्टीमेटली सक्सीड हो जाएंगे. अब डिपार्टमेंट के ऑफिसर के रवैये को तो आप और मैं चेंज नहीं कर सकते ना. वो तो मोदी जी चेंज नहीं कर पाए, उन्होंने प्रॉमिस किया था ना टैक्स टेररिज्म एंड कर देंगे. अगर ब्लड के अंदर वो वाला DNA चला गया है 70 साल वाला, कितने ऑफिसर्स के दिमाग से निकालेंगे? देखो ये एग्जाम्पल यही तो मैं देखता हूँ. मेरी ब्रदर से एक दिन नोकझोंक हो गई कि बोला नरेंद्र मोदी गवर्नमेंट का क्या फायदा हुआ, घुस तो उतनी चल रही है. मैंने कहा एक फायदा तो हुआ कि आज बम ब्लास्ट तो नहीं हो रहे 2014 के बाद आज तक, क्योंकि सारी रेमेडीज पॉसिबल नहीं है लॉ में. चाहते तो मैं भी हूँ कि मेरा ऑफिसर, मेरे ऑफिस में भी 10 बंदे काम करते ठीक से चले. एक दिन एक समझ जाता है तो दूसरे दिन दूसरा लेट आता है, तीसरे दिन तीसरा गड़बड़ करता है, क्योंकि वो DNA घुसा हुआ है चाहे प्राइवेट और गवर्नमेंट ऑफिस हो. आज तक आपने गवर्नमेंट ऑफिस पूरी लाइफ में ऐसा देखा कोई ऑफिसर अपनी चेयर पे बैठा मिले? मैंने तो बचपन से नहीं देखा, इसलिए मेरी फाइटिंग स्किल बनी. नहीं तो फाइट करने की जरूरत क्या है? मैं अपने बच्चों से पूछता हूँ कि हम बाहर विदेशों में घूमने गए हैं, कभी मैंने आज तक ऊंची जबान में किसी से बात की? क्योंकि वहां सिस्टम से काम होता है. जो आपने भी क्वेश्चन ये किया, यहाँ पे जो पढ़ के जाते हैं उस सिस्टम से काम नहीं होता. यहाँ पे तो पैसे नहीं दो तो कहता सिस्टम डाउन है, सिस्टम डाउन है. अभी सिस्टम डाउन है, बस एक ही बात आती है. अब सिस्टम डाउन ही रहता है क्या इस कंट्री के अंदर? और उसको पैसे दो तो सबके सिस्टम चल पड़ते हैं। तो ये चीजों का आंसर कोई भी नहीं दे पाएगा आपको, ये तो इस सिचुएशन में ही आपको फाइट करना पड़ेगा।
ओके सर, थैंक यू।
कुणाल, कुणाल बुद्राजा जी,
मनोज कुमार जी,
सर ऐसे तो चेयरमैन सर ऐसे सेशन अनएंडिंग है, इट्स ऑलवेज प्लेजर टू हियर जेके सर। या लेकिन क्वेश्चन कुछ ले लेते हैं सर हम।
जेके सर इट वाज अ वेरी ब्यूटीफुल सेशन, बहुत मजा आया सुन के और काफी रिफ्रेशिंग था। पर जैसा कि आपने कहा कि ये 3B और 2A मैच नहीं होगा, ये मिसमैचेस ऑलमोस्ट हर एक डीलर के केस में रहेगा, तो डिपार्टमेंट ने तो एक रवैया बना लिया, उन्होंने तो नोटिसेस भेजना चालू कर दिया। अब हर एक केस में अपन कोर्ट ऑफ लॉ में तो नहीं जा सकते, हमको तो आखिर फाइट डिपार्टमेंट से ही करना है। एक मिडिल साइज प्रैक्टिशनर फर्म SCA फर्म, वी डोंट हैव द लिबर्टी, या हमारे पास एक वो नहीं है कि हम हर एक केस कोर्ट ऑफ लॉ में लेके जाएं, और हर एक केस में अपील में जाने के लिए 10% अमाउंट पे करना है, तो ये काफी डिफिकल्ट सिनेरियो होते जा रहा है। मुझे तो ऐसा लग रहा है मेरे हर डीलर के केस में मेरे को अपील में जाना पड़ेगा, क्योंकि ऑलमोस्ट एवरी डीलर हैज अ मिसमैच केस, एंड हाउ टू डील विद दिस सिचुएशन, थोड़ा आपका नॉलेज इसमें दीजिए सर।
अच्छा क्वेश्चन है, पहली बात तो मैं आपकी सारी कंटेंशन को एक्सेप्ट करता हूँ, जो आप कह रहे हो बिल्कुल यही होता है, हर आदमी कोर्ट में नहीं जा सकता है, और 10% का आपको टैक्स भी जमा कराना पड़ेगा प्री डिपॉजिट। इसी का फायदा उठा के तो ऑफिसर ये झूठे नोटिसेज और ऐसे काम करता है। वो आपका इंडिया के अंदर ये एक सिस्टम बन गया है कि हाउ टू एक्सप्लॉइट द सिचुएशन ऑफ समवन, तो एक्सप्लॉइट कर रहा है। तो इसका मिडिल पाथ कैसे होता है कि कई बार क्या होता है ना, जैसे घर में 5 बच्चे हैं तो एक बच्चे को टॉफी देके बताया जाता है, एक को थप्पड़ मार के बताया जाता है, एक को सुला के समझा के बताया जाता है। तो आपको भी थोड़ा सा तो दिमाग में ये लाना पड़ेगा कि ये टफ सिचुएशन है। तो जैसे मैंने बताया कि कुछ केसेस में आप कंप्लेंट करिए, अगर आपके पास ये मेरा केस होता तो मैं एक कंप्लेंट प्राइम मिनिस्टर को भी करता। आप ये मत सोचे कि प्राइम मिनिस्टर पढ़ता है कि नहीं पढ़ता है, प्राइम मिनिस्टर खुद कभी नहीं पढ़ता है, लेकिन प्राइम मिनिस्टर ने अपने, जैसे मेरे पास कॉन्टैक्ट आता है कोई कॉन्फ्रेंसिस का, तो मेरे भी ऑफिस में काम कर रहे होते हैं ना, वो कॉन्टैक्ट करते रहते हैं, लिंक आ गया नहीं आ गया, PPT चली गई नहीं चली गई, प्रोफाइल भेजना है, तो सिस्टम हर एक जगह बने। दूसरा, 100% केस में भी एक्शन नहीं होता है, अगर 10-15% केस में एक्शन होता है उतना भी काफी रहता है, 100% केस में एक्शन की रियल में जरूरत भी नहीं होती है। आप खुद देखें, अगर टीचर क्लास के अंदर एक बच्चे को जोर से चाटा लगाता है पूरी क्लास चुप हो जाती है कि नहीं, सबको चाटा लगाने की जरूरत नहीं होती है। तो आपको इस सिचुएशन में डील करना है कि ये एक प्रैक्टिकल डिफिकल्टी है। एक चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट इंस्टीट्यूट के थ्रू भी आप अपना डेलीगेट दे सकते हैं, नितिन गडकरी जी तो आपके पास ही रहते हैं, वो इसके मिनिस्टर नहीं है, बट लेकिन व्हाट आई अंडरस्टैंड हिम कि वो प्रॉब्लम सॉल्यूशन जरूर है, उसको अगर थोड़ा सा करते हैं एंड तो आप उनके पास भी कर सकते हैं, हम कैसे मिले। एंड तो ये भी कुछ कंप्लेंट करिए, कुछ डिपार्टमेंट को रिप्रेजेंटेशन दीजिए, कुछ केसेस को फाइट आपको करना पड़ेगा। कोर्ट तो मैं लास्ट रिजोर्ट बता रहा हूँ, कोर्ट जाना एक समस्या का समाधान नहीं है। आज मेरी बेटी को मैं एक लेक्चर, उसका कॉम्पिटिशन है, सी यूज टू टेक लॉट ऑफ कॉम्पिटिशन में पार्टिसिपेट, कि आयुर्वेदिक अच्छी है या ये एलोपैथिक अच्छी है, तो मैंने उसके लिए लेक्चर तैयार करवाया। मैंने कहा यू कांट कंपेयर यू नो बोथ थिंग्स, बोथ हैज आयुर्वेदा और एलोपैथिक में देखेंगे तो आयुर्वेदा का जन्म तो बहुत पहले का हो रखा है, तो आप जो बात कह रहे हैं उसमें बहुत सच्चाई है। इसलिए तो मैंने कहा सुप्रीम कोर्ट भी इसको बात को कंसीड कर रहे हैं। जब आप एक बार कंप्लेंट करना शुरू कर देते हैं एक दो की, कोई ना कोई कंप्लेंट पे एक्शन जरूर होता है, ऐसा तो कभी मत मानना कोई भी कंप्लेंट पे एक्शन नहीं होता है, और जैसे ही एक्शन होना शुरू हो जाता है किसी की तो फाइल पे कालिक पोती जाती है, किसी को डिसमिस कर दिया जाता है, किसी को ट्रांसफर कर दिया जाता है। मैं एक लाइव एग्जाम्पल दूंगा टाइम की शॉर्टेज होते हुए भी, ताकि आपको बूस्ट कर सकूं। मैं SOCHM का केस डील कर रहा था, जैसा मेरे प्रोफाइल में बताया, मैं वहां को चेयरमैन, और आज से नहीं हूं, 15-20 साल से मेरे को छोड़ना नहीं चाह रहे, मैं कोई पोस्ट का भूखा नहीं हूं। तो उनका एक 38 करोड़ रुपीज का टैक्स का डिमांड आ गया, उन्होंने किसी और बहुत बड़ी लॉ फर्म को दे रखा था, अल्टीमेटली उन्होंने कहा मित्तल साहब हैंडल कर। अच्छा, मेरा एक प्रिंसिपल है, सेट प्रिंसिपल, मैं मदर इंस्टीट्यूट से कभी पैसे चार्ज नहीं करता। मैं इंस्टीट्यूट का भी आज 200 करोड़ रुपए का केस कर रहा हूँ, सी इंस्टीट्यूट का। मैंने कहा था पहली कंडीशन है मैं पैसे नहीं लूंगा एक भी पैसा, आपको ट्रस्ट हो तो कराना, बोला कि नहीं आप ही को करना है। तो इसी तरह मैंने उसका, तो उसने कमिश्नर ने, मेरा जूनियर वहां पे गया, मैं तो नहीं जाता हूँ कमिश्नर के पास, उसने वहां पे था ही नहीं कमिश्नर, तो उसने कहा सर मैं क्या करूं, मैंने कहा एक चिट्ठी लेके वहां पे लिख दो, आए और नहीं मिले और वो चिट्ठी पे स्टैंप लगवा लो, लगवा ली और हम झगड़ा कर लेते हैं, हमारे स्टैंप लगा के देनी पड़ती है उनके ऑफिस वालों को, वो देते नहीं है किसी को। अब उसने 30 करोड़ रुपीज की डिमांड भी कंफर्म कर दी, पेनल्टी भी लगा दी, सब कुछ लगा दिया। मैंने कहा कि हम कोर्ट में जाएं, मैंने कहा ये तो एसोचैम है, और कोई होता तो अभी तक उसका हार्ट अटैक हो चुका होता, नहीं कोई कम अमाउंट नहीं है, 30 करोड़ रुपीज इंटरेस्ट, 30 करोड़ रुपीज की पेनल्टीज एंड डिमांड वगैरह करके, मतलब आपका 100 करोड़ रुपए का केस। उन्होंने कहा जो मर्जी कर दो, आपको जो करना है। तो मैंने कमिश्नर के बारे में सीधा कोर्ट में बोला, और देखो गवर्नमेंट एडवोकेट इतना विजिलेंट था, वो कमिश्नर को पहली पर्सन में बुला लाया, बुलाना नहीं था उसको क्योंकि भी तो कोर्ट ने नोटिस भी नहीं किया था, बोला मित्तल साहब का केस है ऐसे नहीं होगा। तो मैंने सीधा कहा जज को, मैंने कहा कमिश्नर अपनी बीवी के साथ घूमने गया हुआ था, ये दफ्तर में बैठता नहीं है और इसने पूरा वो कर दिया। वो कह रहा नहीं नहीं ये आए नहीं, आए नहीं। बोला मित्तल साहब के ऑफिसर वहां पे गए थे, आपके ऑफिस से स्टैंप लगा रखी है, अब तू बता दोबारा कब सुनेगा, ये ऑर्डर तो गया। और उसी ने फिर दोबारा सुना, और दोबारा सुनने के बाद उसने लिखा नील लाइबिलिटी। आप समझ गए ना, वही ऑफिसर है, वही क्लाइंट है, वही एडवोकेट है, वही एनवायरमेंट है, नील। जैसे ही नरेंद्र मोदी आए सबसे पहली मैंने उनकी कंप्लेंट की, और वो अगले दिन मेरी कंप्लेंट पहुंची। अब उसका पता नहीं है कि वो डिसमिस हो गया, ट्रांसफर हो गया, क्या हो गया, उसकी शकल किसी को नहीं पता है। तो जब यू मेक आउट ए गुड केस उसमें आप कंप्लेंट करें, और मेरा टाइम लगता है इसमें, मेरे को प्रॉफिट नहीं होता, ध्यान रखना आप सबके दिमाग में ये है, मैं बहुत बिजी रहता हूँ, मजाक नहीं कर रहा, लेकिन जो भी काम करता हूँ आनंद से करता हूँ। अभी भी मैं चाह सकता था 1.5 घंटे में खत्म कर सकता था, तो मेरे को आनंद आता। आपको लगता होगा कि नहीं इतना क्यों समय, यही एक भक्ति है जिसमें आप खो जाते हो। मैंने बताया ना, जिस दिन मैं नरेंद्र मोदी को एक कंप्लेंट कर देता हूँ, अगले दिन मेरे को 2 नए क्लाइंट आते। ये मेरे पूरे ऑफिस ने विटनेस किया 2014 से आज तक, क्योंकि जब हम देशभक्ति में जुट गए, हम कोई पर्सनल गरज से थोड़ी लिख रहे हैं, आप बताओ। तो आप ये तरीका अपना के देखें, आपकी लाइफ में सुधार होगा। आपको ये मैं बता देता हूँ, चाहे घर वाले हो, चाहे पार्टनर हो, चाहे पड़ोसी हो, कहने में लेंगे आप टाइम वेस्ट कर रहे हो। वो टाइम वेस्टेज है कि इन्वेस्टमेंट है, फ्यूचर बताएगा। आप मान लेंगे वेस्टेज है तो भगवान आपको कभी प्रतिफल नहीं देगा। आप मानेंगे कि नहीं ये मेरा एक ऑब्जेक्टिव है तो मैं गारंटी लेता हूं, मैंने मेरी लाइफ में रोज देखा है। इसलिए आप भगवान से डर के कहता हूं, मेरे को 500 बड़े से बड़े क्लाइंट बता चुके हैं, 500 चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट एंड एडवोकेट बता चुके हैं, कुछ लोग जो जज की पदवी पे बैठ गए हैं वो भी बता चुके हैं। बोला आपके नाम का इतना टेरर है डिपार्टमेंट में, अब बताओ मैं कोई टेररिस्ट हूं, मैं कोई हथियार रखता हूं, मैं किसी को थप्पड़ मारता हूं, मैं किसी को गाली देता हूं? नो, उनको टेरर इसलिए कि ये हमें एक्सपोज कर देता है और हमारी गलतियां जहां हम करप्ट होते हैं पकड़ लेता है एक मिनट। तो ये चीज आप अपनाओगे, अब ये तो डिफरेंसेस रहेगा ना, देखो कभी मैच कर सकता क्या, आप बताओ? आप तो चार्टेड अकाउंटेंट हो, मैं चार्टेड अकाउंटेंट हूं, या आप जानबूझ के मिसमैच करते हो? ये तो होगा ना, जब बिजनेस करोगे कभी मैच किया है। अब आपसे वो कहते हैं कि इनकम टैक्स की बैलेंस शीट और कंपनी एक्ट की बैलेंस शीट और जीएसटी रिटर्न मैच करवाओ, कभी कर सकते हैं? ये मैच करना है तो सब लो एक जैसा ही कर दो। आपके रिटर्न भरने का टाइम अलग है, आपके मेथड अलग है, आपके टैक्सेशन पॉलिसीज अलग है, तो मैच करेगा ही नहीं ना, इसको कौन समझाएगा? तो आप फाइट करोगे, मजाक नहीं कर रहा, आपके दिमाग में ये तो बैठ जाएगा ये ऑफिसर सब निकम्मे हैं और देश को चूटने में बैठे। मैं लाइव ये स्पीच दे रहा हूँ, आप ध्यान रखना कितने लोग सुन रहे होंगे, कितनी रिकॉर्ड होती है, और उसके बावजूद भी मैं ये बोल रहा हूँ तो इसका मतलब मेरे पास कंक्रीट एविडेंस है। मेरे को दुख होता है, मेरे को कुछ बोल के अच्छा थोड़ी लगता है। हम ऐसे देश में क्यों हैं कि हमारा देश सुधरना ही नहीं चाहता? ऑफिसरों को सुधरना चाहिए कि मिस्टेक होती है पोलाइटली बोलना सीखना चाहिए, हर एक से धमकी भरी बात करते हैं तो ये गलत है। और आई एम श्योर आप मेरे को साल भर या 6 महीने के बाद मिलोगे, आपका बिल्कुल ओरिएंटेशन चेंज हो जाएगी और आपको लगेगा। आप ये मत सोचना 100% केस में सक्सेस होगी, वो तो इस देश में कोई भी इंस्टीट्यूशन चाहती ही नहीं है ना। तो इसलिए इसलिए आपको एक सेटिस्फेक्शन आएगा और आप धीरे धीरे चेंज में बदलाव लाएंगे। आप ये नागपुर में भी जाके ऑफिस में पूछना कि जेके मित्तल का नाम लेके तो क्या रेस्पॉन्स और रिएक्शन आता है, तो आप अपने आप ही मेरे को बता देंगे।
सर यार लॉट मेनी पार्टिसिपेंट्स जो थे कुणाल, एक्चुअली काफी लोग ज्वाइन नहीं कर पाए थे शुरुआत में। आई स्टिल रिमेम्बर नागपुर में रेडिसन होटल में एक प्रोग्राम था, उसमें सर की पूरी स्पीच चली और इनके स्पीच में नॉर्मली बहुत फ्री एंड फ्रैंक ओपिनियन होता है, सिंप्लिसिटी ऑनेस्टी दोनों कंबाइन होती है उसमें। इतने सारी चीजें अगेंस्ट में डिपार्टमेंट के भी कही गई थी जो एक्चुअली प्रिवेल करती थी, एंड आई वुड से कि जब ये जैसे ही सेशन खत्म हुआ, चीफ कमिश्नर जो बाद में सीबीआईसी में मेंबर बने थे, उनका कहना है, एके पांडा साहब थे, आई वुड नेम हिम, तो उनका कहना है कि मेरे को जेके मित्तल साहब से मिलना है एक बार। तो उसके बाद में तुरंत लंच टाइम में सब उन्होंने लंच छोड़ के ही वॉज ज्वाइनिंग यू फॉर यूर ऑनेस्टी एंड यूर कंटेंट। सर ने हमेशा जहां पे भी रहते एक नया विजन रहते, थॉट प्रोसेस में चेंज लेके आते। That's why we all love you too much, sir. Actually, सुनना चाहते हैं आपसे। एक है कि नागपुर ब्रांच इज एन आउटस्टैंडिंग ब्रांच है, हमेशा थॉट प्रोसेस में नई चीज लेके आते हैं। चेयरमैन, जहां ऐसे लगता है कि सीपी अवर्स के बिना अटेंडेंस नहीं हो सकती, मोर देन 150 पीपल्स विदाउट सीपी अवर्स ये सेशन में पार्टिसिपेट किया है। यह नागपुर ब्रांच ये साकेत बगड़िया जी एंड हिज टीम जो इस पे वर्क कर रही है, और थिंकिंग प्रोसेस हमेशा अलग होती है। एंड सर, आप लोगों से नई थॉट प्रोसेस में एक चीज और आई है अभी, जो आपने कहा है कि वी हैव अ पर्सन, अ मेंबर ऑफ पार्लियामेंट फ्रॉम नागपुर जो एक्चुअली बिलीव इन रिजल्ट एंड एक्शन, ही कैन डिलीवर बेटर। एंड अनदर टास्क इज गिवन टू द चेयरमैन सर नाउ, अब इनडायरेक्ट टैक्स कमेटी का जो नया रिप्रेजेंटेशन है, इतने सारे इश्यू प्रिवेल करते हैं, तो इनडायरेक्ट टैक्स कमेटी का पूरा इश्यू इंडिया से टेकअप करके विद द प्रेजेंस ऑफ जेके मित्तल सर, गडकरी जी के साथ में एक मीटिंग अरेंज कर सकते हैं। ही इज वेरी कंफर्टेबल एंड वेरी इजीली एक्सेसिबल फॉर वी पीपल। तो सर, एक दिन मित्तल साहब को पूरा दिन नागपुर के लिए जरूर निकालना है, हम लोगों से मुलाकात भी करनी है, और गडकरी जी के साथ में विद इनडायरेक्ट टैक्स कमेटी इंडिया चेयरमैन कैन सर कैन टेक इट फॉरवर्ड। नाउ आई हैंड ओवर द फ्लोर टू सीए संजय अग्रवाल जी फॉर हिज सेशन। तो सर कभी कंप्लीट नहीं होगा आपके साथ में, पूरा दिन भी बैठेंगे तो आधा अधूरा लगेगा, मन नहीं भरेगा सर आपके साथ में कभी भी, बट समवेयर वी हैव टू एंड अप द सेशंस। आई वुड रिक्वेस्ट सीए संजय अग्रवाल जी फॉर हिज फॉर्मल वोट ऑफ थैंक्स। संजय भाई।
थैंक यू नरेश भाई, वास्तव में सर का सेशन करने के बाद बहुत कुछ सीखने को मिला एंड प्रैक्टिकल अप्रोच के साथ है। डियर फ्रेंड्स, अ वेरी इंफॉर्मेटिव सेशन बाय एन अमेजिंग अथॉरिटी इन जीएसटी सीए एडवोकेट जेके मित्तल सर हैज मेड दिस इवनिंग वेरी फ्रूटफुल। थैंक यू सर। फ्रेंड्स, नाउअडेज द टर्म ऑफ फेक इनवॉइस, समन्स, अरेस्ट, circulated transaction are commonly used by the GST authorities for threatening the dealers, and we are facing such thing, and in today's session all these terms are very effectively explained by CA JK Mittal sir along with case laws with related to that term, which will definitely benefit to us in pleading the client before the GST authorities in future. Sir, a lot of thanks for making this top 10 series knowledge ki paathshala under GST very successful with practical approach. Thank you sir, thank you very much sir. At the last but not least, I thanks to all participants for making this session successful. Thank you one and thank you to all. Thank you sir.
So before we conclude, I would just say that it was a privilege for Nagpur branch to have Mittal sir here. Sir, ये session आपने बोला था कि आप शुरुआत में आप केवल 3-4-5-6 ही cover करेंगे, but sir आपने पूरे 10 commandments, I will say 10 commandments आपने cover किया, and you really made this the top 10 series. So thank you so much sir again. We are really privileged to be here. I feel not only from Nagpur, from all parts of the country. The participants in this session are not only from Nagpur, they are from all the parts of the country. Sir, really privileged, and thank you so much. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you. We will meet very soon. Thank you so much.
Sir, a lot of thanks.